Okay, are we there? Oh, we're live. I think we're live. Hello, everybody. I'm looking at my preview. It looks okay. I had a tiny problem when I was trying to log in then, but it seems to be going okay. Can I do a sound check and make sure that everybody can hear me? Hello, everybody. I can't see anything coming through as yet. There's always a delay, though, so I'll wait a few seconds. It looks like it's all working. Can anybody hear me? Hello, yes, a creeping Talon. Delightful name. It's the Vartan Panasian. looking forward to the release of Atlas Empires. I am really excited about it, I've got to say. Hopefully, oh, thank you for saying my sound is fine. Yeah, very excited about the game. It's really fantastic when I get to see my little game assets in an actual game. It's something that's just so joyous to see. I suppose it's every artist's dream, isn't it, to see the final product. Hello, Monkey D. Haran, Jeffrey Griffiths, Vartan Ponisane, No Roach, Burt Bluetooth, hello again. I'm recognising a few names. I was going to say this sounds perfect, but there's me coughing away. Breezy Lynn, good that you're following along my tutorials, that's nice to know. VFX Guru G, you use Blender, good to hear. We all love Blender here, don't we? nice to hear from you all. So today I'm going to be making, you can see it there, I've set up my screen this time so I won't be in the way, my head won't be in the way of anything that's going on. So you can see that I've got, where's my mouse gone? My backpack here, and that's what I'm making today. So I've been asked to make a icon. It's actually only an icon, it's not actually a real game asset, but it is an icon, so that is a game asset. But I'm going to make it in the way that, because they want me to keep the same style, so that sort of stylized look, hand-painted. So that's what I'll be working on today. So it will be still in that sort of low-poly style, low-poly asset. So it'll have sort of chunky edges, and it would be suitable for game. It won't be completely optimized, so I won't be putting all the objects onto one texture map, which I'll talk about a bit when we get there. Hopefully it will all make sense. So, do you play video games regularly? I hardly play them at all. I had a go at Dragon's Dogma recently, but just didn't get time to get into it. I'm so busy doing other things, and I am more a creator than a player, if that makes sense. I've been working through your Sea Shack tutorial. I'm glad you're enjoying that. That was good fun making it, in fact, and it was good fun communicating with everybody, asking for different things and then coming out with a new tutorial as well. So hope you get all the way through. Let me know if you've got any problems in the comments below. And afterwards, do let me know if you've got any thoughts and ideas for the stream. I'm really just going with the flow at the moment and just trying out ideas with the stream. So hopefully you'll bear with me with these things. I do want to continue the sculpt that I was doing and do some hand-painted stuff on that as well. But I haven't got around to... Well, I haven't decided whether I want to do a retopology stream because I just feel like it's going to be boring, but then people have been asking for it, so maybe I should be doing that. So we'll see how we go. Anyway, I'll read a few of the comments first. I've got to try, apparently, not to look at the comments all the time because that's distracting and I don't get any work done. So I'll be flicking in and across and out here and there. Making the table and chairs, good. So people are enjoying the exercises, which that's been very popular actually. So I will continue doing those blend exercises. There's a playlist in my channel and under the playlist. I'm trying to organize my videos as well. So do go to the playlist section where hopefully they're a bit more organized. We're following you from the Middle Ages. This is inspiring me to make assets. Good to hear, but Bluetooth. Breezy Lynn. Grateful for the tutorials. Thank you very much. Sat down to part four practice. Good stuff. Well, you can listen to me whilst doing it. No, you can't listen to me twice. So that wouldn't make sense. just completed the low poly building exercise. Good. Hello, Artemage. Hello, Lizard. Are you in Sculpt January? No, not doing Sculpt January this year. I'm just way too busy. It's couldn't get into it, unfortunately. But maybe next year. I imagine this sort of busy patch that I'm going through is not going to last, but I've been thinking that for a while, and the jobs are sort of piling up, and I'm not getting to them all. So we'll see how we go. Yeah, but I'm all about personal growth and growth of the channel and doing exciting new things. So there's always going to be something new and interesting happening, hopefully, in my mind. Hello, Default Q. Don't delete me. I'm not going to delete you today. I'm going to start with the Default Cube. you have to sacrifice playing video games to make video games. Yeah, it seems strange, doesn't it, Creeping Talon? Alkesh Rayo, I love all the hearty faces. And Bederan Debus, let's do it, mate. Yes, indeed. Red John, hello. Yes, you have time to see my work live. That's good to see. So hello to all. I struggle with the retopology all the time. Yeah, that's, do you know, I struggle with retopology, and I think that's why I'm nervous to do it live. Because, you know, when you get to those points and everything's joined in, you think, oh, I've got a five there. How do I turn that into a, oh, it's just a headache, isn't it? And sometimes you have to end up with some triangles, dare I say it, triangles, yes. And also it's not just the retopology itself, is it? It's trying to get the flow. So let's say you've got a retopology around here, let's say. You've got to try and get the flow so you can get that crease, because when you get old, like me, you get creases here. So I'm looking at myself to see how old I look. So you've got to have that flow of retopology as well. And if you want to add edge loops, then you've got to have them in that flow. Anyway, enough about retopology. No one wants to hear about that. So I'm going to make this backpack, Gamer JDeck. I'm just sort of saying hello to everybody, and then we'll step right into it. Ultimate Loser, hello. 12 a.m. here, as in like midnight or midday. I'm assuming that's midnight, because it's 12 p.m. if it was midday. God, there. Blend fans, thumbs up. There's a thumbs up from me, because I am a Blend fan. I got 9 out of 10 in my volume and space subject in graphics design grad. Thanks for your tutorials. That's good to hear. It's always nice to know that people are going, doing it on their own, and they're going off and looking on the internet, looking at my tutorials, going back and doing their assignments and doing well because of my tutorials. That's lovely to hear. You're very handsome. Thank you very much, VFX Guruji. Guruji? I don't know. Thank you very much for that. Do you already have a tutorial on how to proceed after I've sculpted a high poly model and retopologize it? Yes, I do. I did a face. It's not 2.8 though. That's the only thing. I've got to update for 2.8. But I've done a face series, and I've done a Spartan Warrior series. I've also done a dinosaur that was in 2.8, but I didn't retopologize manually. I did that as an auto retopo, which is naughty. This is never as good. Jonathan Gonzalez, Grant, can you make me some babies? Only in 3D. I don't do babies otherwise. I don't have kids, and I don't want kids. I'm inherently selfish. It gets in the way of my YouTube empire that I'm building. It's really kind of people to say I'm handsome. That's lovely to hear. very strange. 5 o'clock in the Netherlands there, Omar Cam. Nice to hear from you. And it's just, I get caught up just reading the comments. So I will actually start in a second. What time are we? We're 10 minutes in. I better stop it, VFX Guruji. Wow, there's another one. So as I said, I was on Discord. I said, oh, I'm going to start a live stream in a minute. And I can't remember who it was who said, I don't want to be involved in the live stream because it's 2.8 and I'm not using 2.8. And there's someone else who's saying, I can't be involved because it's 2.8. It's interesting, people going back to 2.79. I feel like I couldn't go back now because there's so much that, like, I use Eevee all the time because it instant renders, and well, I say instant, 2 second renders. It speeds up my workflow massively. I do use Cycle for still frames every now and again, but only for the shadow catcher, really, because you can get pretty good results with Eevee. And that's just Eevee. There's all the sculpting tools as well. And I like the, in fact, retopology we're just talking about. There's a retopo tool now, and it's just, there's so much happening. And the remesh option. So that's a retopo tool that does it automatically built into Blender. It's not brilliant, but it's good for sculpting. So 2.8, if you're struggling, the struggle is real. Definitely, it's frustrating. It's things in different places, but But do it. Make the change. Go through that pain, because there's a whole new world out there. That's my advice anyway. Okay, so let's start off. Do keep chatting though. I will answer questions and things like that. But let's start off. This is interesting because, weirdly, I haven't done a sort of modeling live stream yet. I've chatted to people about freelance stuff, talked about portfolios, and done some sculpting. Sculpting I find easy. But I suppose because I did the Sculpt January, and not that I'm an amazing sculptor, but I find it easy to do it live. Whereas this, I'm going to find a little bit more tough, I think. So we've got the can we see that image? Yes, we can, over there. Just checking. And we're going to start with the default cube, yay. So I'm just thinking if anything I've set up that will get in the way. I think we're all okay, aren't we? Just have a quick look. Okay, let's start off. So, oh, actually, well, that's what I was going to do. I knew there was something I was sort of missing in my head. So let's bring this in over here. This is just a few reference images I've got, just a few. So I've got something to look at. Just every now and again, you think, well, how do you paint that, model that? And you just you haven't got it fully in your head, and reference images are so important. So spare the cube, indeed. So having a look at what other people have done for their backpacks. So this isn't, it's the, not what's icon? It's not the shop, it's the inventory. That's the word I was looking for. Inventory icon. It's that. So I've been sent this graphic here. Yep. And this thing, I'm in front of some of it. So yeah. So it's sort of along that sort of style. Hopefully that makes sense. Hello, Soul Skinner, OG, which is Inhella, and it got lots of different aliases, haven't you? So I've got some other backpacks in here just to get some ideas. Now, this is interesting to me because I'm looking at some of these. This one on ArtStation and other places. Look really great. So this one looks fantastic. But I think the final render lets it down a little bit because it's really glossy and it's got a sort of sheen to it. And I don't know why they would have gone for that. Maybe it was just the texture didn't quite work when they brought it into something like Sketchfab or something. I find this one as well, it's a little bit sort of plasticky looking. Not that I should be critical, because these are lovely pieces, aren't they? Really fantastic. But what I do like is more this sort of look. It's got a softer look. It's not 3D, it's hand-drawn. If we can get closer to this sort of style, I feel like there's a bit more contrast there, a bit more of that sort of tactile feel to it. So that's what I'm going for. I like the shape of this one as well. So I might bring out the base of this one so it's got a bit more of a sort of plump back sack feel. I thought this one looked really cool, but I've got to keep within this style a bit more, I would say. I like this sort of chunky buckle here. I do quite like this scroll as well out the edge. And I've already done a scroll in a previous one. In fact, I'll show you that because I have got a time lapse on that. Where is it? If I can double click on this. Oh, that's a Photoshop file, isn't it? Right, it's going to come out like that. Oh, it's all going haywire on my computer now. Right, so I'll just move my stuff around. Move this here. Move this over here. So I'm in Photoshop. Oh, that's... So here's what I've done with the... What icon was this? This was the... Learn? I think it was Learn. I can't remember which icon. But I had lots of fun with this, with the scroll and the potion bottles and stuff. Yeah, so I might reuse this scroll coming out of the backpack, but I haven't decided yet. But that's to come. Watch this space on my channel. I don't think I've... No, I haven't posted that one yet, have I? No. I'm losing track of what I've done and what I haven't. But anyway, that's that. Let's start modeling. So just double check that there's nothing else interesting happening on here. Model February. Yes, that's what we need, isn't it? It's made of chicken. I don't know what that's in reference to. Oh, we've got lots of people watching today. We've got 158. Hopefully I won't let you all down. We'll see how we get on. good things require sacrifice. Everybody wants to delete the default cube. It's not happening today. It is not getting deleted. Let's move across. What I'm going to do, I'm going to go straight into edit mode and start thinking about the shape. So get the shape to start off with. So Control R to do a loop cut around the middle. And I suppose actually I should mirror it as well. So I'll do an auto mirror. If you haven't got the add-on, auto mirror, well worth it. It's under the edit menu. I've got the loop tools as well, well worth it as well. Someone was saying it wasn't working for them in 2.8, but I find it fantastic. I'm going to turn this camera this way a little bit. Ooh. You're all coming with me, whether you like it or not. I can't see how that's working at the moment, but hopefully, where's OBS gone? Come back, OBS. There you are. Okay, that's better, I think. You can see my light in the background, but you don't mind that, do you? Yay, it was spared indeed. The Blender Foundation is going to buy Natron to make it more like Nuke. Is that actually fact, or is that you wish? Stop the stream for a second, because a Natron is sort of compositing tool. If you know Nuke, I call it Nuke instead of Nuke, then it's node-based compositing. It's basically industry standard compositing, and it's lots of layers, but it's like After Effects, but better. Where you've got lots of layers like smoke, the 3D models, the background, and all that sort of thing. So it's amazing. So is that the case? Because Natron is like a free version of Nuke, and it follows the whole layout and interface quite well, apparently. I've not used it, but this is what I've heard. And I really wish Blender Foundation did actually do that, because that would be something. I mean, nothing surprised me anymore with Blender, because they just do incredible stuff. Suddenly, Epic's giving them loads of money, and Nvidia is Nvidia. Anyway, everybody's giving Blender Foundation money because they know there's something there, and they're coming out with all this, like the sculpt tools at the moment are looking good. So anyway, back to this auto mirror. I'm going to go in the x-axis, so auto mirror in the x, and you just have to press auto mirror, and you can see it adds a mirror, cuts it in half, and does the clipping for you. So that's a great little tool there. Yes, After Effects and Nuke are different things, yeah. But I would say Nuke is kind of more industry standard. After Effects is more for motion graphics, if you're going to use it professionally. And they do it in different ways as well. I use After Effects a fair bit. I said a fair bit, not that much really. But I can use After Effects. Okay, so I was saying I want to plump out the bottom a bit. So let's grab those bottom faces. Alt, left click, in fact, screencast keys. Thanks to JNM. I keep forgetting to he's updated the screencast keys, if you'd like to know that. Just chatting away and telling you all these things that you don't need to know. But he's updated these, and I keep forgetting to download it, so I need to do that. But screencast keys down there. So Alt, left click, and let's scale that up. So we've got a sort of bag-like shape, and let's grab the whole thing, or select the whole thing, scale in the Y. Okay, so it's got a more rucksacky feel. It's always tricky. You sort of think, do I do a loop cut now or do I do it later? And that's part of the fun of modeling and the frustration of modeling, is I always think keep it as simple as possible for as long as possible. But sometimes you think, well, I have to start creating these shapes. And I'm thinking, do I create this pocket now or do I get the shape a bit more first? What I'm going to do is I'm going to go for the shape a bit more first. So I'm going to bring this out here. And already I'm liking this a fair bit. That's great. So let's, I'll grab these two faces here and inset them and scale them in the Y. Always do that. Let's scale that up a little bit there. Okay, somewhere around there, and extrude that out. So these are going to be the side pockets. And there we go. It's got a sort of chunky, it's very basic at the moment. You don't need to go that detailed when you're hand painting, surprisingly. And you can get away with a lot, but I'm going to need to do more than this. Don't worry. There's more. For only $9.99, you can get this beautiful rucksack. What am I talking about? I start getting a bit crazy when I'm doing this sort of thing. So sorry if I go crazy. I'm just evening these things out. That makes a bit of a difference sometimes. Even topology. It does help. It's hard to explain then. Right, so I've got a bit of a gap here. Do I want that gap? Probably not. So let me think. I mean, I could have done loop cuts up here, but there's more topology than you need, and I quite like keeping this simple for the top. But I will answer some chat in a second. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut down here. I love the knife tool, and I use it quite often. In fact, I am, for now, I'm going to use... You see, my process... And probably most people's process, when I'm doing tutorials, it's very different. And I've got it set in my mind exactly how I'm going to do it. And I cut bits out. So I probably might have cut a fair bit of this out, but you're seeing it live. So you're seeing the rough version of the Gabbitt, as it were. When you're modeling, you're probably deciding a lot as you're going along. So I'd rather than think, right, I'll cut here and do this beforehand, like a climber assesses a wall before they climb it, decent climbers do. Whereas I just like to get in there and play around a bit. I think I will have another mirror. And we're going to go in the negative with the Y, because that will appear in the front then, like this. That way, I can grab this one, GG, and GG. Now, what I've done, I've made a mistake. I knew that as I was going along, honestly. I did it on purpose. There is, under these options here, there is an auto merge option. So in your tools, when you're just generally in edit mode, there's under the options, this tool options here, active tool and workspace settings, you've got auto merge. Make sure that's ticked. So anything that's sort of touching another vertices, so when you, in this case, GG, and slide this down, now they become one vertices. So we'll undo that, because I don't want that. In fact, I ought to save my work now, because otherwise, who knows what will happen. It always appears on my main screen when I save work. It's frustrating. Where are we? So we need a new folder for, what icon is this again? It's not info, it's inventory. Inventory icon. Can't get to stuff. Inv one. Right. Let's quickly look at the chat. Okay. I'm new to YouTube live stream stuff. Me too. can I watch this later when the live stream's finished? Yep. I always they're always appear on my channel. So yep, you can have a watch of that. And do comment in the description. Comment below. with any thoughts you have about how I can improve, good and bad, please. Although I do love the good comments, it's good to receive proper feedback in terms of proper feedback, but you know what I mean. And criticism is good for me. Any other questions? Been a long time since I played Duke. Didn't know that I don't know what that 45 years. I don't know what that's talking about. Sorry, Unleash 75. I don't know what you're talking about. Probably commenting to other people, so I just got in there. cut away from yourself. Mind the pointy bits. I'm not sure what people are saying. I see. So cut away from yourself. Yes. Did you know that's quite a clever thing? The knife tool. Be careful when you're using the knife tool, I think is the comment there. yes, indeed. Odie man. At this point, because I forgot to set my tool with the auto merge, I'm going to need to select all. Let's make sure I'm on, yep, with A. And then Alt-M is the shortcut for the merge tool. I don't know where it is otherwise, actually. It's probably under Vertex, is it? Vertex. I don't know. Alt-M, just remember the shortcuts. People always say, why aren't you using these tools down here and stuff? Because you need to get used to the shortcuts. It's so much faster. So Alt-M, by distance. And we can see down here, remove two vertices, which is these ones down here. That's cool. So when you're doing hand painting, that's 3 to face mode. I'm going to scale these down. And there's this thing that I was reading, and it's quite a clever thing. I'll scale them in the Y as well. In fact, you grab in the Y because of the mirror. Try not to have things that are, I don't know what the word is. So if I scale them up again like that, try and have them sort of come inwards. It's easier to paint. So you're trying to make it a bit more spherical all the time. And in fact, I think that will suit the shape anyway. Yeah, it's sort of working in my mind anyway. Tell me what you think. So let's bring those up a little bit. Watch out for that cut. I might have to do a loop cut up there because that looks dreadful, doesn't it? Let's be naughty, put some triangles in. But then we've got this awful looking thing there. Let's just grab that. That's okay. It's low poly work. You don't have to worry. It's more about what it looks like. But it makes it easier to model if you're modeling in quads. And I can just cut across here, can't I? That's fine. I'm not sure what I'm doing at the moment. I'm just playing around tidying up. Anyway, so we've got a really rough shape there. Is that your only reference photo? No, I have got some others. I did show them earlier. You could quickly go back and see what the reference photos look like. But I've got them on my screen up here. In fact, I'm going to full screen that so I can start seeing them again. There we go. I'm looking at my reference images. So I'm not really following this completely. I'm not sure if this is from... this is Chris Handlauser is his name, is the lead artist. He does some really great work. It's fantastic. And I will talk more about that in some other videos, I think. Absolutely love his stuff. I'm not sure if this is his work, actually, or he's just sort of said it needs to look something like this. But it's his sort of style, so it could well be. So we're roughly copying this style, but adding a bit more of my style to it. Hopefully he doesn't mind me doing that. How do you get to make game props to game like you do? I've tried everything to make money on modeling. I'm lucky. I've got a YouTube channel and people are enjoying the content, so I think really I got the job because I've got a YouTube channel. I've got the ability to do it, but it's more because I can promote the stuff a bit, talk about the stuff, and they were able to see me on YouTube. So it's not easy finding work, but there is work out there. It is all about having an amazing portfolio. That is the main thing. Do comment as well if you think that I'm spending too much time commenting on the comments. Or if you've got any thoughts about what I'm doing or any questions. I don't mind if people sort of post things twice because I've missed it in the stream. So don't worry about that. But don't spam too much like some people have in the past. Anyway, Atlas Empires is out February, apparently. So I'm really excited. I'm wondering if my phone's going to be good enough, though. It really is. It's a Samsung Note 4. And it's just starting to play up. It really is. Twitter stopped working the other day. Gmail stopped working. And I'm thinking, it's new phone time, surely. I have had it a long time. Thank you, CG Monster Tutorials. Your comments are lovely. And so I take it you must have some tutorials of your own. yes, get to work. Thank you, Shikama. I will do just that. So let's get back to work. So looking at the shape, Am I happy with this shape? I feel like maybe the top needs to come in. I'm just going to experiment a bit. So perhaps like this and then sort of coming down here and over the top there. Do I want... I'm feeling like a scroll out the side, which I saw in one of my reference images as well. Just sort of having a think, really. I think as well I want these to... I'm going to grab in the X there. Just come in a little bit. So it's, like I say, this sort of spherical shape that I... it's not always the case, but sometimes you sort of change the shape, but I'm thinking spherical like it's a sack that's sort of been chucked on the floor. Hopefully that makes sense. Maybe for that matter we need to, I've gone around the back there, this bit here, grabbing the Y, bring it out a bit that way. Okay, so we've got a sort of a chunky rucksack. I may have gone too far with these bits here. So you can see my process. It's sort of very fiddling around, just playing really, figuring things out. I mean, it's good as well to try things out. Does this sort of style work? So it goes out at the top. Let me know what your thoughts are. You can have an influence on the Atlas Empires icon that is the backpack, the inventory. I'm going to change that to inventory as I keep looking at it saying the backpack icon. I suppose it is really. But does that work? I don't feel like it does, I suppose. But then you can have sort of hourglass shapes. I used to be quite into drawing caricatures. Not that I was very good at it, but I think it's good practice to try lots of different things. And you had set shapes, like hourglass shapes or potato shapes and things that you would use. So thinking about those sort of base shapes, I'm not sure that's working. So I'm going to undo those and keep, with the rounded style. But I think... that does need to be a little bit more squared off about there. So backpack looking. Okay, so fairly straightforward stuff at the moment. Right, so the tricky bit when you're making low poly assets is when to start adding topology or when to paint it on. Because I could just go with this and start painting buckles on and paint this sort of front piece here. But it does help to have a bit of substance to it. You've got to think about the silhouette. So if it's to be seen from this angle, and we would see the lip of the top of the rucksack there, we'd see the buckle probably from about here as well sticking out. So I will add those in. So let's have a think about how we're going to do that. Probably the simple way is to grab these two, and I'm going to go for that sort of distance. That needs to be lower down, actually, I feel like. So I might, dare I do it, another loop cut. But that seems too low. Let's see, maybe around here. We'll try that. So three, I can always, that's the thing, you add topology, but which you need to be careful of and don't go overboard adding stuff that you don't need. And I will probably drag these up there, there and there to get rid of them because they're unnecessary in a way. But you can always take it away as well. So I can always select my edge loop and dissolve it. So delete and dissolve the edges, we'll get rid of it. Okay, I'll undo that because I need it. I will upload the video onto YouTube, Grace KK. So let's grab these and extrude them. Just a slight extrude and scale in the X. Somewhere around there. So it's got that sort of top of the rucksack. I'll select these two and just grab them in slightly. So it's only a slight lip there. And then these edges, whoop, edge mode, and G then Z. Okay, so it's got a bit of shape. I feel like we need a bit more, so a loop cut down here. And we're gonna get this sort of shape around here now. There we go. Oh, it's looking delicious already. I feel like it still needs to be a bit more spherical. A bit more spherical, like this perhaps. Yep, I'm liking it. How are you liking it so far? Do let me know. What's going on here then? Oh, Donald Trump, nice to see you there. Big fan of your work. where are we? Just having a look at... yep, it'll be on my channel. Is that the image they gave you? Yes, that's the image they gave me, but they're not too worried if it changes and I adapt it in some way, which I'm certainly doing at the moment. I'm making a bit more round, a bit more plump at the bottom, as if it's got more things in it. Why would a backpack be delicious? Sometimes shapes are just delicious. I want intrusive notifications spammed at me when you go live. I always miss your streams. Yeah, I never know how much to advertise. I put it on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. So if you can follow me on those. Follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Subscribe and blah, blah, blah. I thought it would be notified, but YouTube algorithms, they don't notify people. And it's so what I've got, YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter is what I'll post on. And I post the video up early so that people can see it's coming. So it should sort of appear for people, hopefully. Donald Trump there. Love it. I fully expected Frank to be here taking the mickey. Yep, I'm sure he'll turn up if he can. right, just having a look through. Yep, some people sort of selling their stuff. Go ahead, I suppose. But it's held for review because you're trying to sell. Check out my stuff. Is I think I have to say it's okay for them to kind of advertise. But yep, if you like. And. Be careful, ArtKid. It sounds like you might be upsetting people. That's the problem, isn't it? You try and get out there and you try and show off your stuff, but you can easily upset people as well if you go too far. The main thing, if you're trying to sell yourself, make sure you're really good and keep practicing. And when you're really good, the stuff will come to you. People will come to you. Turn on Super Chat. I thought it was automatic, but I don't know. I think it is on, isn't it? Super Chat? Let me know. Do you think my stuff is ready to be sold? I can't remember. Have I seen your stuff? But Bluetooth? Yes, I have. It's tricky to say. Some people might buy it, but I'd always want to get to the next level. But you always put it out there. But don't be surprised if people don't buy it, and don't sort of spam areas saying buy my stuff, sort of thing, because people will let people know your stuff's there. Yes, but and try and sell it, but try and keep getting better and keep getting feedback for your work. That's the thing. Okay, so let's carry on. Super chat is enabled on mine. Yeah, so it is enabled. Super chat. What is super chat? Is that so people can support me? I think, isn't it? And people can have their questions highlighted or something like that. Oh wow, there's 215 people here. Thank you, everybody. That makes me feel really happy. I wasn't expecting that. I thought because we were a bit earlier in the day, that might be a problem. But it actually helps me if it's earlier in the day, because I feel like I had an internet engineer out because I went down the other week. And they said, it's just your cable network's bad. It's aluminium instead of copper in this area for some reason, saving money probably. So unfortunately, I'm stuck with it unless I did some satellite thing or something, and I'm not sure that would work any better. But if I come on a bit earlier, then the whole estate isn't on, sort of thing, if that makes sense. Anyway, you don't want to hear about that. Someone quickly make a 500 euro comment just to test it. Yeah, someone test it, whether the super chat's working with $500. 500 euro would be fantastic. Could you do a text engraving tutorial with text and booleans? I'll probably do a video on that, because it's quite a nice, easy one to do. Anyway, I need to carry on, don't I? So I've got this backpack. It's not looking too bad. Where's my mouse gone? I moved my mouse over to that screen and I've got them set up in a weird way. Do I need them over here? Maybe. Let's do that. Let's just do a quick... Actually, what's the best way to do that? I think I'll just do a quick cut down here. Again, a little bit naughty, but it's okay. It's okay to have triangles here and there. Let's just extrude that out slightly and then grab this top one and GG, good game, and slide it down. I'm going to also grab this face, GG. Oh no, you can't GG a face, can you? What are you doing, Grant? Typical silly mistakes from me there. So if I edge slide, that's going to be awkward actually, I can't edge slide. So three, and then front view, that's side view, Grant. G, and do it by hand, there we go, coming down there. That's fine. Okay, let's have a look at the design. I want this to come down to edge mode there. GG. Oh, that's not sliding, that's interesting. Why are you not sliding for me? I don't really want to do that one by hand. Let's GG that one. And G, then Z. This one, that's going to bring it in slightly. Shouldn't matter too much. And just by eye. You can generally do these things by eye. I know I'm not so keen on all the snapping tools, because I feel like they just take too long. So just doing things by eye at the moment. And when I... So what you end up doing in the end is shade smooth it all. And it looks all weird, doesn't it? But when it's hand painted and you've got that shader on it, it doesn't. Let's go back to shade flattener. Anyway. Any other thoughts? You can select vertices and then make GG. Was that right? Can I do that? Let's have a look. I don't think, because they're all looking for an edge to slide on. Yeah, that it does make sense, but they're sliding the wrong way. Yeah, that's a good point though. I need to learn some more things about snapping and stuff like that. I'm sure that'd be better. Oh no, not the N-gons. There's no N-gons around here, only triangles. Only triangles. But it's still... I think we're okay. Is this software... McDonald Trump. Let's not be critical of Trump. There's no need to get political around here. if you're on Discord, one of my Discord admin is quite a fervent supporter of Donald Trump, actually. How about that? So I try not to say too much, because I'm not really a big fan. But then I get this sort of British press, which might be very critical of him. I don't watch Fox News, which I think are the opposite. Anyway, let's make a buckle. I mean, this has got a sort of lip around it, but I think I'll probably draw that on. This icon here, I think I'll bring that up to this area here. So I'm going to put that sort of interesting, intricate thing there and have some buckles and straps down here. So let's make a buckle. Buckle, I might as well make that as a separate object. Right now I'm working for CG Trader Wildcat, but how I should start to make short films. Making short films. I want to do that as well, actually. I think that'd be good fun. Slightly too busy at the moment, but that's a future goal of mine, is to make short films or games. I haven't decided yet. I suppose that's one thing. If you're finding you're not getting much luck making games or whatever it is, then working for a games company, then perhaps make your own game. Sort of bypass the middleman, as it were. It's easier said than done, because obviously you've got to make a living somehow, haven't you? So I'm just sort of making this buckle here. I'll probably sit it on top like that would probably be best. Into edit mode. And do you know, I'll do a mirror is probably going to be the easiest way. Have I rotated this? I don't think so. So auto mirror on the Y. Yeah, that's fine. And then I'll select this face, inset, and delete. And then, actually, is that a big enough buckle? I think it probably is. And then select these inside edges, Alt, left click, E to extrude in the local Y would be the best, won't it? Because I've rotated it slightly. Lots of people ask me that. So obviously the local access and things like that. So let's go to item. Let's go to object mode, sorry. And you can see that I've scaled it and I've rotated it a bit. So I can press Control A and reset the rotation scale, but I don't want to do that because I've got access to, if I grab in the Z axis, in fact, let's grab in the Y, you can see that's the Y axis and that's going this way. What if I want to use the local Y? Well, I press Y twice and I've got the local axis. So that's why I don't want to set the rotation. And sometimes you want the scale to be able to do that as well. So there is a reason not to set the scale, but even though I say it all the time in my videos. So chunky or roundish buckles. I think we need an auto mirror in the X as well, actually, for this as well. So where are we? Edit, auto mirror X. Let's do that. And what have we got? And then Z, of course. Yeah, Z. There we go. So that's nice to be able to just model one quarter, isn't it? So I can now make it more curved. How are we looking there? It's a tricky one, isn't it? Actually, I'm probably better off bringing these out. Let's still scale X. Bring this one out. G, then Z. Scale and Z. Okay, a little bit more rounded. And then let's scale it in. And if I go into edit mode now and press Alt-S, that will scale by the normals and make it fatter. So scaling by the normals there. Clever stuff, eh? I could have used a bevel there, couldn't I? Yep, that's a good point. I saw someone say bevel. I do a bevel. There we go. I do a bevel. Yep, should have done a bevel, actually. I mean, I could still do a bevel. Look, there we go. That's Control-B. Not liking the style there. I probably need to make this a bit bigger. I want chunky thingy-majiggies. Something like that. Do you know, I think that's wrong, actually. Doesn't look right, does it? No. Done that wrong. In fact, I'm just going to go back quite a few steps there because that looks shockingly bad. I've undone my auto mirror though, so let's go back to the mirror. X, Y, and Z, there we go. I quite like the chunkiness, but you're right. You are right. Let's do that. Control B. Do a bevel there and give it a bit more. Yeah, that's a bit better. I think it needs a bit more curve, so on these ones here. And here, let's scale them out a bit. And now we've got probably a better looking buckle. I probably beveled that too far. Undo that. Oh dear. That's why I don't want to do this live, really. let's make it wider first. We'll do this and this. Scale them out. Nope, let's do it one at a time. Scale inwards first with that one, and then outwards with this one. Have I got that? Scale outwards. Yep, so we got the rounded look. Okay. It's embarrassing, this, isn't it? Embarrassing. Embarrassing, everybody. And then let's bevel that. probably just a little bit like that. Let's just zoom out a bit. Ah, there we go. Buckle. Oh, beautiful. It took me long enough, didn't it? Now, to be fair, I'm only doing that because it's an icon. If this were for game, I wouldn't have done any of the bevels because it would have to be much more low poly. If you're keeping the real true low poly, then make sure you don't add these extra bevels. There's no, I don't think it's necessary. Okay, I'll mirror that, I think. So I'll add another mirror, so mirror modifier, but I'm going to mirror it across using the rucksack as my point of mirror. Let's move both of them up. So G then Z, and actually if I put them in here, that's quite nice because it's against that flat curve there. Hopefully that makes sense. So what I mean is that it's following the curve of this. When it was G over here, I'll undo this in a second, but it's the rucksack is digging into the buckle and it doesn't look so great, but let's undo that. There, it's not digging in. So that's going to look nice as a buckle. Let's just rotate it so it's a bit flatter about there. Lovely job. Okay, let's have a look at the chat. So people are suggesting ways of making this. Maybe rotate a little bit. Yep, that's glad you said that. So people talking about PlayStation games? Something like that? Yep. And just having a look at what people are saying. Isn't he from Spain? How long is it? I'm not sure who you're commenting about there. I'm not from Spain, if that's who you're talking about. We have to... don't say if it's embarrassing. I'm only joking that it's embarrassing. It's not... I'm not that... I suppose I am vain, but not that vain that I worry too much. I'm fairly confident that I'm going to come out with something reasonably okay at the end of it, so I'm not too panicked yet anyway. We'll see. I always do myself down as a bit of a joke, really. I never get hand-painted metal looking quite right. Neither do I. It never feels right. It's easier when it's static, so it should be a bit easier for this because it's an icon, so I can sort of paint on some reflections a little bit. But it's frustrating. It does look like an angry robot. Yes, it does. It's going to look better soon. Flipping angry robot. It really does look like an angry robot. Quite right. Do you normally use the inset or extrude scale? It varies, Little Wolf. It varies a lot. I believe there are two vertices in one spot in the corner of the pocket. Since you enabled auto merge later, I didn't. It didn't merge them, did it not? Let's just double check. I think we're okay. I can press go to select all Alt M and just up the distance a little bit, but we've got none there. Down here we can up the distance a tiny bit. No, I think we're fine. I'll up it a bit more and then you should be able to see something disappear there. That disappeared, so I think, whoop, if I go back. Yeah, no, I think it's fine. try not to swear on the live stream because then I have to show your comment. And I always feel a bit awkward showing swearing because it's naughty. You know it's naughty. but not that I really care, but just in case it offends someone. I always try and keep everybody happy because I'm that sort of person. Yeah, subscribe to this guy. Love his beard as well. You're loving the beard, are you? it's laziness. That's what the beard is. It's not too bad in this light, but it's going a bit grey in certain patches like about here. And it looks like I've spilt something. Or they've been drinking milk and it's not good. many people load in a standard human model as a reference model. Yes, that's a good idea, actually. I suppose I could for this rucksack, backpack, whatever it is. Oh, it's mirrored, isn't it? That's why that's a bit sticking out there. But it's only going to be seen from this angle for the lighting. But in if this properly, I would obviously apply the mirrors and delete this back face and all this sort of thing and have straps on it and things as well. You said no N-gons, but you do on the side pocket, do I? Oh, I got an N-gon somewhere. Let me see. Ah, there is. You are right. Oh, I failed. There is an N-gon. How dare there be any N-gons? Now, that's interesting because is it making any difference? Not that you are right. There is an N-gon there. I forgot about that one. Because it's flat, you can have an N-gon that's flat like that. It's fine. And it won't make too much difference. What is a good idea, though, is to not have thin triangles like that. So GG, just flatten it out just a touch and even it out. So they're not sort of short, thin, long triangles. It can glitch when you're hand painting in that case. I'm a lazy shaver too, Griffith, sorry. But I can't stand it out. Yeah, it starts itching, doesn't it? Hey, thank you very much. Alan Lima Marquez, if I pronounce it right. I learned a lot from your videos, man. Thanks. I'm waiting for my tablet to start the hand-painted course. Yes, you must have a tablet to do this. I tell you, it's so difficult without. Right, anyway, I need to move on. Otherwise, I'm never going to get to painting, which is hopefully we'll get there this time. Yeah, otherwise I'll have to do one tomorrow as well. Bob Ross painting in 3D. Only happy accidents. Okay, let's do the strap. Let's get... So this probably needs to come out a little bit more, doesn't it? To fit a strap in the side here. I'm sort of trying to be careful when I say this strap. For some reason, it feels like there's an innuendo coming out somewhere around there. Thank you again, Alan. Much appreciated. So for straps, I use a plane. Let's scale that down and rotate it in the x-axis 90 degrees. Okay, we got that there. And we're just going to need to adapt it. Well, not that way. Rotate Z to the shape of our mesh a little bit. Somewhere around there. And let's rotate it out there and move it into position. Okay, that's looking good. Somewhere around there, just a little bit of adjustments. Right, so this strap has to come through my buckle. I'm just sort of seeing how it works with buckles, actually, because the backpack doesn't have the strap coming through, and is that going to be okay? Because it's a much easier way to model it. But a strap should kind of come through, really, shouldn't it? But weirdly, it works, doesn't it? So maybe it doesn't. Let's have a look at my other references, because whenever you're in doubt, go back to your reference. That's my students always say, so what do I need to do now? I can't think of ways to make this better. And I say, well, go back to your reference images. And they say, I haven't got any. Of course they don't. Frustrating students. So let's have a look at my reference images. I'll bring them onto the screen so you can all see again. So thinking about the buckles. I like this one. Do you know, I love this piece of art, actually. I'm going to go a bit closer to this than this. So it's sort of somewhere in between the two, but a bit more of this sort of shape. That's what I'm thinking. And again, the strap just sort of follows it down, doesn't it? I like this chunky look here. Maybe I need to do that with mine. Maybe not. Thinking about it, whether it was going to work or not. This is a bit too detailed, really. I've got it there, but it's a bit too detailed. Let's have a look at some of the other ones. That does come through, and that looks nice, doesn't it? Oh, that looks good. Interesting. But I don't really want to be doing that. That would be one model there, and one in the middle, I suppose. Tricky one, that. Do I go for that look? I mean, there's also time factor as well. You've got to factor these things in. And that comes through as well, that one. I think that looks pretty nice there. I like that. So I'll probably make the strap come through a little bit, I reckon. So let's get rid of Pure. This is PureRef, by the way, that reference image tool there. Very useful because it puts itself above things and you can drag things into it. It's just, look up PureRef, have a go at it. Hey Grant, could you do a favor please? What is it? Just Chris. What else have we got on here? Will you use normal matte baking for this? Nope, it's all hand painted. Just plain and solidify. Yes indeed, Kevin Vink, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Hello GD Odissi from Russia. Graphic designer. Cool. And you're learning English. So hopefully you're learning some English from me. Tell me some Russian so I can speak some Russian to you. I am trying to learn a couple of languages. I'm having a go at Spanish, having a go at French. Not doing particularly well. I'm not particularly good at that sort of thing. But when I take a car journey, I have a CD in the car. So let's extrude this out this way and just see how that's going to look for the time being. So I'm just extruding it very simply for the moment. So it's going out like that, and then I'll bevel this one. So it's coming into it like that. Oh, it's a bit wibbly wobbly. One of my favorite phrases, if you listen to any of my videos. Yeah, it's a bit blobby, I sometimes say as well. There we go, simple strap. I probably want a bit of character to them, so they're going to sort of come out like this. Ooh, that's too far. GG. And rotate it. Scale it out a little bit. This one, GG. Scale it in just a touch. So it's got that element of character as if it's been misshapen. So don't keep everything straight lines. Get it sort of misshapen if you can. Can you use Blender to make a 2D dungeon map? Yes, I think so. I've never tried it, but I can't see why. Why not, sorry. I enjoy your videos. Thank you, Chris. I think it's funny how you started doing streaming after I mentioned it. Did I? Is that right? Quite possibly. A few people sort of suggested it, so you may well have been one of them. Thank you very much. I have loads of fun doing it. Not sure quite why I'm having so much fun, because it's quite a nerve-wracking experience. Wow, 250, almost 260 people. Goodness me, how about that? but thank you everybody for watching. Tell me where you're from, people, as well. I like to know where people are from. I don't know why that is. It's just this wonderful thing about the internet, isn't it, that we can chat to people from all over the world. I can't read that, I'm afraid. Jinsei? Yeah. I haven't got any. I can't read the Russian either. Probably shouldn't have said speak Russian to me. Yeah, bad idea. I think you could just position the camera looking straight down on a plane. I'm not sure what you mean there, actually. Adrenaline Junkie Grant. Yeah, I think that must be it. Dallas, Texas. See. South Africa, Germany, Cumbria. Close by. South Africa. Another one from Texas. California, Nepal, Netherlands, South Africa. Oh, it's great. I don't know why I find this so interesting. Holland, Turkey, Netherlands, Dallas, USE. I think you might have slipped on the keyboard there. is that just me? The White House, Donald Trump, of course you are. a Korean student. Ah, cool. Is that the first from Korea? It might well be. Someone pretended they were from North Korea, of course, but I very much doubt they were. So many South Africans. Yeah, there was that. Good lecture. New Zealand. My brother's in New Zealand. Armenia. Portugal, Jordan. Oh, this is great. Another one from Cornwall. No, that was Cumbria, the old one. Cornwall as well. There we go. Russia, Switzerland, Greece, Germany, Slovakia. Oh, this is amazing. China. Yeah. Using a phablet or mouse for modeling. I'm using my mouse at the moment for modeling, and then I'll use the tablet for painting later on. Where are we? Across the pond. I'm assuming that's America. Mars, España. We're in the same country, hey, but Bluetooth. Hope the rucksack will open. No, I can't be bothered for that. I don't need it to open, you see, so I'm not making it open. Now, I don't know why I'm finding this so interesting and intriguing where people are from. Minnesota. Faroe Islands. Yeah. On the orbit. Mm. United Arab Emirates. Emirates. I don't know why I couldn't say that. Emirates. United Arab Emirates. Why can't I say that? Sorry, I do apologise to you. I didn't mean to say your country wrong. Brazil, New York, India. Oh, this is great. I don't know why I'm... Again. Absolutely loving it. okay, so back to it. Let's continue. So, yeah, as someone was suggesting, just with the modifiers now, go to the solidify. And let's up the thickness. And you notice that's going backwards. Is that correct? So it's a good idea. Let's go to object mode. And in here, you've got face orientation. And you know it's all the right way round when it's all blue. If it's red, then it's wrong. Red is wrong, in this case. I'm just seeing, yep, Istanbul, yeah. Where are you from? I'm from the UK, sorry, I suppose I probably should say where I'm from. Ipswich in the United Kingdom. It's about an hour away from London, on the train anyway. Not too far from the capital. I think there's a Blender talk in London soon, Blender meetup. So I may go along to that. if anybody's interested. But you're all from far too far away. Area 51. Oh, good one. Where's this, the strangest place we can suggest we're from? Let's get face orientation back. Okay, so let's also add a modifier to this and mirror it to the other side. Do you notice I'm having trouble with my speech today? Mirror it. Okay, let's use our rucksack as the object. And it's looking kind of cute as a little rucksack. Again, the details we've painted on. We're getting fairly close to a point where I can say, yeah, I'm happy. Do I need to put some sort of dent in there? Now, because this is low poly work, if this was, let's say, a character for a game, and not a mobile game, but you needed to keep the polygon count down a little bit, or maybe you just wanted to go for the low poly style, then you can add more polys in than this. Am I making sense here? Even maybe a mobile game, if the character was going to be seen loads, you could, again, have a few more polygons than this. But remember, it is a backpack. But if it's, like I say, if it's going to be seen all the time, in this case, it's only for an icon. So although I say this low poly game assets, I'm trying to talk in the sense that we are doing low poly game assets and give all the hints and tips. It is only for an icon. So I don't have to worry too much about the polygon count. So I can come in here into edit mode, hopefully. And you can say OA3. I don't know. Soulskin, I can't say that. Michigan. When I apply the mirror, someone's saying you could lower one of the buckles slightly. Yes, indeed. CG Monster Tutorials. I'll have to check out your channel. So it must be good. But yes, change the give it some character, change the buckles and so forth. I will do that later on. And I'm deciding thinking about the way I unwrap it, I'll probably make this an instance of the other one. And then, so I only have to paint one and then move one down slightly. Same with the strap probably. But then afterwards, just adapt them really slightly so they've got that shading. And then when I paint the rucksack, that's a tricky one. I'll probably paint the rucksack. I'll unwrap it all. I'll apply the mirror, unwrap it all. And then, because you need the shading, you need to be able to draw on the shading so that I'll be drawing shading in the background of this buckle. So I will mirror it to start with. And then when I move the buckles, that's when I'll put in the shading and things. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. Why did you initially mirror the buckle in the Y to create the main shape? Why did I do that? Oh, just in case, let's go into, I've lost my mouse again. Why have I moved my mouse all over the place? Let's click on the buckle. So I only needed to create this front corner section. And so when I'm editing this bit here, it will work on the back as well. So I've got that sort of curvature to it. It may not have been necessary, to be honest, but it's just there if I want to, let's say, move this, then it will mirror in the back as well. Hopefully that makes sense. Please type in your email. I need models done. I'm working on a project. I'll pay you, do it. yep, grant.abbott@gmail.com. That's easy enough. So my name, my YouTube name, you can see there, grant.abbott. abbitt@gmail.com. You should be able to find it on my channel, actually, anyway. And I've got my Instagram link there, Twitter link, so you can contact me if you like, and you'd like me to do some models. I'm pretty busy at the moment, finishing off Atlas Empire's, got loads of other projects as well. Might show a few on here if people are interested in the workflow. I can kind of kill two birds with one stone. I can do some YouTube and have fun, and I'm doing my work at the same time. What a beautiful life I live. Okay, so back to the rucksack. Where was I? So at the top here, I'm thinking grabbing these top faces. Let's go to face mode for that. And inset them. Now you'll notice on the inset, the more astute of you, is that I've got one at the middle here. You just turn boundary off for that. Okay, so I've got that, and then I can extrude that inwards. And then I've got that sort of lip to my rucksack. I'll scale it in as well. And can you see that sort of lip effect that's happening there? I'm not sure I'm liking it that much, so I'm going to bring it out a bit more there. And I need to soften and round these corners a bit. So this edge flow here, I'm just going to sort of scale it in a bit. Will that work? Scale it. Oh, that's D I'm pressing there. Scale that in a bit. Just to soften it a bit. And this one here, scale that in. It has scaled a bit weirdly there, so I'll just by eye do that. Make sure. I mean, it gives it a bit of character as well, so it's not really a problem. And again, I say that it's a bit high poly, really, but I just wanted to give it that section there, so it had that lip that we've kind of got here. Although I'm changing the shape slightly. Is that shape okay? Do you think? Maybe it needs more rounding at the top here. I think it does actually. Let's move that up and move this up as well. That's better, actually, isn't it? What do you think, guys? Is that better? I think it looks a bit better like this, personally. Just going to move these in a bit this way, though. Yeah, I feel like that's better. Let me know. Oh, I've lost some of the chat. What are people saying? I need Jets cards and a large building made. Cool. I mean, there may be people on here that you can have a look at their portfolio as well. I'm not the only modeler. And I reckon there'll be some people on here who are good enough to help you out. They will probably be cheaper than me as well, because I'm able to charge a fair bit now because lots of people want me. No, Grant, you belong to Atlas Empires. Oh, no way. Is that? It's not really, is it? Sam, are you on here? Thank you very much. It's been an absolute pleasure working with you, Sammy. Sammy, so what is your position? Because Sammy's basically my boss, but I don't want to say what your give you the wrong role, as it were. But he's the boss. I'm a little bit nervous now. He's watching me do it. He's watching me work. No, oh dear, go away. well, hopefully there's loads more work for Atlas Empires, and it's going to be a great hit. You can see from the joy that people I'm bringing to people's lives with Atlas Empires here. So hopefully it's going to be a great success and you'll want me forever more. And I'm very excited to do more work for Atlas Empires. Grantis Empires, that's what it should be called. Are you listening to this, Sammy? Oh dear, that's caught me by surprise. Now I'm a little bit taken aback. So Sammy, what is your actual title? Because you're like the top big cheese. I'm not sure quite how we say it. Anyway, it is good to see you here, though. I'm sure you probably haven't got much time, though, with your empires that you're running, Atlas Empires that you're running, were you? thought it'd be cool. Yeah, exactly. Grant thought he would be cool by working at home. Suddenly, the boss steps in. Funny stuff. Loving it. Oh, wow, there's 280 people watching. That is amazing. It's really crazy. I can't see Sam anymore. He's not there anymore. So I've scared him off. Anyway, so yes, there we go. Just Chris. His budget is close to $6,000. Wow. That's... you're taking me away from Atlas Empires. How long have you been doing 3D modeling? Yeah, let's get back to the stream and doing some 3D modeling. It's in total, it's probably somewhere like 20 years, which is a bit crazy, but it's really on and off. I was the first time I got into it was when I was doing a sort of a film company with my friends when we were in university. And we started a little film company and we were doing some cool projects, but it wasn't enough to sustain us. And it was really quite a new avenue for the digital. It was the advent of digital film, weirdly. It's that long ago. CEO and founder. There you are, Sammy. Thank you. You are CEO and founder. You really stumped me there, Sammy. You killed me. That's my background. It was in film, and I wanted to do 3D for film stuff, but slowly went away from it into teaching, and sort of fell into teaching a bit. And that was just media studies, because my degree was in media studies. I didn't have games design then. I would have definitely done games design, much rather done that. We're doing these little films, but our companies kind of died after a while because we just couldn't get enough work in. We all went our separate ways doing our separate things. And then I was teaching media studies and then went into games design only in the last 6 years or so. I was still doing the odd job of Blender here and there. Well, a student, it's a school, it's about 12 years ago, a student came up to me and said, you can do some 3D stuff, can't you? I must have mentioned it in one of my IT lessons because I was an IT teacher then. And I said, yeah, and he had an uncle who wanted to build this yacht and he wanted to see it in 3D. So that was one of my first contracts. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting away from the rucksack at the moment. Just having to think about what the next stage is, really. I need to do this design here, don't I? So I need to... Do I hand draw that, or do I... that's a tricky one. I mean, it would be nice if it was quite chunky, but I am taking up a lot of time. So Sammy's probably watching, thinking he needs to get on with some work. So let me think. I mean, what do you think? Should I... Can I get away with hand-painting this? And just painting it on, or does it need to be a separate model? What do you think? Comments in the description. So in terms of my history, shift right click to move the cursor, by the way, and I'm going to use a plane to make that model. I am actually going to model it. I think it will look better. I'm probably going a bit overboard, as always, when I'm on live stream, because I just feel like it justifies it somehow. So, where are we? Anyway, I was talking about me. How about that? So I got back into sort of, I was still doing a bit of 3D modeling, just a little bit still here and there. And then slowly, hand painting, people are saying. Yeah. So I'm getting distracted. Oh, and someone's outside as well, my door, so it's all happening. Where were we? Slowly got back in, still doing a bit of 3D, slowly got back into it, and then games design as an option for teaching came up, and I thought, yes, I want to do that, I want to do 3D modeling. Getting back into Blender, absolutely loving it. Then I thought, do a bit of YouTube, because I was teaching anyway, so then I could YouTube about the stuff that I was modeling and, teaching. And the rest is history in a sense. It sort of grew until this point. So that's my background and stuff. It sounds like people touting for work here. Love it. Paint. Everybody's saying paint. Should I model this or paint this? Okay. If it goes wrong in the painting, I can always model it afterwards. So I think you're right. We need to get on and paint, don't we? Is the shape okay? Talk to me, people. Is the shape okay? Is it good like this, the roundness? I'm starting to think actually maybe this sort of curve and the original design looks better. It's difficult to tell at this stage with this sort of thing, isn't it? But tell me what you think. Are you attending the Global Game Jam? No, I'm not. Where is the Global Game Jam? How much abuse of the artistic license can you get away with in using the reference? Now, if this was a client who I didn't know very well, and I've sort of got to know Chris fairly well now, I know that he's happy for me to adapt and change things around a bit as I see fit, and he trusts me with that. He'll certainly say if he's not happy about it, and I encourage him to do that as well, obviously, because I want him to be happy and the team to be happy. But I know that I can get away with a bit of artistic license because things sometimes look a little bit better in 3D than 2D or the other way around, and you need to adapt them in order to make it fit that reference image. And I think this was just a guide, really. He was saying, I want something that looks like this. Other things he's been more specific on. The pockets are way too fat. Okay, well, let's try that. That's a good point. I like where you're coming from there. I think you might be right. It's actually, do you know, it's very helpful having all these eyes on me telling me what to do. So let's move that in. Yeah, good shout. Who was that? Diana Kiwi. Diana? I'm sorry, I'm pronouncing it wrong. But that's a good point. Anyway, anybody else? Side pocket should be higher. Looks a bit. I missed that. It's too many people commenting. Looks a bit funny being at the same height as the front. Ah, okay. Let's have a look. Is that right? Oh, the tops of the. So these bits, I think you mean. Does that look better? I think you're right. Oh, another good shout. Oh. You know, this is so helpful. So we changed the pocket. Are we happy with the pockets now? are you guys happy? Do the Do you know, I'm starting to think actually I should have left that as a space now. Do I need a space in here? Do I need this to come in here like this? So I'll just show you what I mean. So if that comes into there like that. Do I need that? I think I do actually, don't I? Oh, do you know, I've messed this up, haven't I? Try an inset on the lower quads to make an outline like you did on the upper. So you think this, I should have an outline like this one? We can try that in a second. I'm going to do tidy up the pockets first, but yeah. Remind me if I don't do that in a second. I'm loving this. I'm loving the feedback, actually. It's really helpful. I would lower the bottom of the side pockets and put to get a fuller feeling and rotate the left and right side of the top so the lip is rounded too. So you want the roundedness coming down here. Yeah, that's probably true, actually. Do you know that's... Oh, yeah, you guys are more artists than I am. Let's see. Front view. G. So round that out slightly. Oh, that's not working, that rotation there. I need to rotate by the Y. Do I need to rotate? Oh, it's too high, isn't it? So I'm probably just going to have to do that by eye again. Oh, I've squished that one. Just sort of taking a moment. I feel like I've butchered that a little bit, but I think we're probably just about safe. I need to dig this in anyway, don't I? Because that needs to come in visually, doesn't it? So a little bit more there. Do they need to be fatter, those lips? Right. See what I think the top cover needs to hang over the sides a little bit. Maybe I do. I mean, generally you paint that on, but perhaps let's do that. Let's do it. So what I can do, I'll use the knife tool for that. Love those N-gons. You know I do. And then I'll just grab that face and drag it. Nope, in fact, grab that edge there and drag it in the Z-axis. Like that. That was a nice, easy one, wasn't it? Yeah, I can paint that bit in. That's fine. Yeah, I like that. Good. It's just great stuff, actually. Just looking at the comments still. Just pull out the corners just a little bit. Which corners? Do you mean these corners? Let's see what it looks like. Just having a think. Was that going to... I mean, we're starting to get more like the reference images, so maybe people are preferring that reference image. Can you notice this is a dreadful N-gon? And I join that up with J. Excuse me. So I've grabbed two vertices, J to join. And there we go. It's going to get loads of alerts on my phone. I say my phone, but it's a watch coming through the phone, obviously. Tear the upper edge for an overhang. I think I just did that. There may be a bit of lag. Do we get a... so are you thinking, if I just... Actually, I don't need that one. A bit more of an overhang like this. Might be working better, actually. I just want to round that out a bit as well. How are we looking? Let me know. Well, that's a bit too much of an overhang now, but I can always bring that back pretty easily. GG. Edge slide. Because remember, the artwork can do the work there, so you just got to be a bit careful underlapping things. It's just awkward to paint when they're like that. This one needs to be GG'd. Edge slide as well, just there. Keep talking to me, people. This is great. The mirror on the rear may be not needed now. Yeah, I'll get rid of that eventually. Yep, and tidy it up. In this, do you ever reference a photo? Yeah. Usually, I will have references of leather as well when I'm painting the leather and things. I'll probably have to look for a few because I haven't got far enough ahead. I think I've got some somewhere else as well, so I will use them real textures and then sort of stylize them. More flat for the spine. When you say the spine, you're thinking, I'm not sure what you mean by the spine, because the spine should be the back here. Oh, so maybe that's what you mean, yeah. But I will flatten that out. For finished objects, any quad? No, yeah, you can go triangles. That's fine. Almost there. Are you doing only this model today? Yeah. you missed my comment, but it is an important one, so I will repeat it. The part of the bag facing towards the back of the person carrying it should be shaped differently. Yes, I will sort that out, don't worry. Static meshes can have triangles, exactly, yes. In fact, animated meshes, if they're low poly, can have triangles as well, but generally, you're keeping quads where you can. Front strip end must be a bit more pointy. Oh, the ends here, the edges. I mean, are we making, I suppose people are obviously liking this shape more than mine. So fair enough, really. Let's, ooh. Oh, I'm going, pressing the wrong buttons. So a bit more square like this, perhaps. I mean, should I? What are people thinking about this pocket down here first? Should I get rid of this quad? I suppose I'll just try it quickly. So enter edge mode, face mode, delete those faces, and then let's, probably the easiest way, do you know, is extrude that out into the middle on the Y. So constrain it to the Y and then fill in the faces. So edge mode, can I press F there? Yes, I can, there we go, F. So I've got that now. And this probably wants to GG it up there a little bit. That's too far, let's undo that. Whoop. G like that. Okay, yep, so bottom of the pocket's wider than the top. Yes, good point. That's another good comment from, I can't pronounce your name. Diana, Kiwi, okay. Sorry, I feel like I need to know your name because you're doing some good stuff. I'm liking it. In a weird way, I quite like the way that comes out like that, but we need a little bit less. I'm just doing this by hand now. It's probably distorting the shape a bit, but it is a sort of rugged rucksack. We're probably going a bit too far than we need to because we can get a bit of the stylization going with the painting as well. The body of the bag looks a bit stiff. Yeah, I think it's this corner here, isn't it? I feel like I keep feeling like that at the moment. What I can do is probably, no, oh, that's an N-gon, isn't it? So I'm gonna have to hold on a minute to cut around here like this. And then let's do Control R around there. And then I can just sort of scale these ones in a little bit. So these here, scale it in. Now that is, that's way too many polys, but don't, I'm not panicked about that at the moment, but that looks a bit softer, doesn't it? Yeah, it looks quite cute. I'm sort of happy with it at the moment. Bottom seems to be more wider than middle, flared or crushed by its own weight. That's what I was thinking, crushed by its own weight a little bit, to give it that character as if it's really full, bursting almost. But maybe I'm getting that wrong. You should put the vertical piece, the buckles, those still. You should put, thank you. Thank you, I've forgotten about that completely. Nathan Turner, appreciate that. Let's just quickly do that. So just there, Shift A, mesh, cube. Oh, that's a plane, not a cube. Shift A, mesh, cube. Hang on, am I still in edit mode? Did I just do that in edit mode? No, I didn't. Scale that down. Full stop on my numpad, or period key if you're American. I can't get away from saying full stop. It's been drummed into me. And do I want that at the bottom or the top, actually? Do you know, maybe I need that linked to the buckle instead. Because it would be, wouldn't it? Would it be? I'm just looking at the other buckles now. Maybe not. I feel like it needs to be at the top here, personally. I think. I'm just sort of talking out loud at the moment. Scale and Y. Scale Z. So I'm doing this all in object mode. So it will not retain its scale. Do you know what I mean by that? Hopefully. And let's something like rotating the X. Something around there. Click off just to see what that looks like. Do I need to dig it in a bit more? Probably do. I might just give this a bevel. I'm rushing now because I want to get onto the painting so I can show you some painting stuff. I'm actually more comfortable with the painting than the modeling, to be honest. So there we go. It's got a bit of a bevel, so it looks probably a tiny bit better. I feel like that's a bit better. And then I can paint the hole in. I will need one for the other side, so let's mirror that. Mirror. Sorry about my lips smacking. My mouth is getting dry. Let's choose the objects. There we go. There it is, our crazy robot. It looks very symmetrical at the moment, and I certainly will want to move those around a bit once I've applied the mirrors. Have you brought any Blender add-ons that you can recommend? No, I haven't actually. It's crazy. I'm a bit naughty because I've got a YouTube channel. I say, can you give me your add-on for free so I can recommend it? So I get a few add-ons for free, which is quite nice. So what are people saying? How way is that? Yeah, is that right? I'm not sure. You should put the vertical piece of the buckles. Yep, we've said that already. Grant, in Model February, if you make that, you should dedicate one day to making low poly assets similar to Atlas Empire's assets on the release of the game. Oh, that'd be interesting. Why are there four extra polys? Already way too much. Yeah, it is. If it was for the game, I wouldn't have gone that high. I'm just making sure it looks quite nice. So it's more stylized at the moment. It's only for an icon. But yes, I wouldn't have done that if it was for the game. Yeah, and that's important for everybody to understand that, I would say. Well, 260, like, we're doing really well with. I'm surprised the people are still with me and going with this. Side pockets, button buckles. Yes, they need some buttons. I'll paint those on. Yeah, I'll paint those on, I think. That's a good point, though. Thank you. Will you model that ornamental pattern in the middle? I may do. I can do that secondarily. So I'm not panicked about that at the moment. But I'm going to try and paint it on, see what it looks like. Might even do layers for that. It looks like we're going to go into tomorrow at this rate. So how many people are up for a live stream tomorrow? I could do a live stream around... probably around... maybe around 4 again if people are up for it. Let me know. The end of the straps must be rounded. Yes, I think they will have to be for the style. So we'll come in here and we will do a loop cut down there. Now, again, if this was for game, I would do this and drag these in. In fact, I wouldn't even do that. I'd cut it because that will take ages. So K, there and there. And then just grab this bottom one and round the edge out. But you must make sure it keeps relatively flat, otherwise it will look weird. As you can see, some slight distortion there, but that's a bit better. Yep, I agree with that. Tomorrow sounds good. Yeah. yeah, I'm not trying to make an exact copy of the reference image. I suppose people are joining late, they're not understanding that. Thank you, that's a good point. Yeah, I'm trying to adapt it slightly. I prefer bigger buckles. I think that's going to be more fun, especially when I adapt the shape a bit in a bit. I feel like the pockets are a bit big still, so I'm going to move those up. GG. I'll just move them by hand this way a little bit. Just around there. I feel like that's a bit better. I'm not sure though. Maybe not. Yeah, I think we're okay there. Okay, I'm going to call it there on the modelling, because I think it would be... shall we just try putting a... can't help myself, can I? Putting a lip around the bottom. I'm going to grab this edge loop here. So Alt, left click, GG to slide it up slightly. I just want to see what it's going to look like with some bulk at the bottom. So extrude, scale, Shift Z, so it's not going to scale in the Z axis. And then I need to... just round it out a bit, and I can do that by grabbing this section here and just pulling that down. So G then Z. I probably need another loop cut, dare I say it. I'm starting to get a bit too realistic now, but I just want to see what that looks like. That looks horrendous. So let's forget about that. What does it look like there? I'll go one forward. I scale this in. It looks all right. So there's with. And without. Let's just go back a few. And without. And with. If it's a bit thicker, maybe. But you see how this one goes, it's sort of artistic license goes under the pocket. So that's interesting. Now I look better before. Bevel the top part of the pocket too. I mean, I'm probably going overboard with the bevels. I think I'll, if I come to that, I'll hand paint it. Atlas Empires forever, doing a fantastic job. This is it. Thank you. Thanks, guys. Without. So, yeah, okay, we're going without that one. Okay, do I need... I don't need this edge loop here, do I? I don't think so, anyway. So let's delete that. Oh, not... delete dissolve edges. Thank you. Because that will be painted on, that detail. So this is where I could go around. If I were doing the game right now, I'd be thinking, right, where can I delete faces? And you know, I could probably get away in here. Of if I were doing the game modeling, I'd press GG and grab these and pull them in all the way to the end, because on the silhouette you can't really see that edge, and we can probably paint it in. So, but I'm just going to leave it for now. But that's something you should be thinking about in your mobile game creation. Is there an N-gon on the... Yes, on the bottom of the strap, let's have a look. An N-gon. There's no N-gons around here. Nope, we're okay. It's all quads. Okay, so at this point, save your work. I like to... Oh, of course, it always goes up here. I want them to change that because my pure ref is on this image and I have to get rid of that. And then... and I always press a plus one, so I've got a second copy so I can go back to the first. Not that I went very far with the first. I might save it again now, and then I can just press and do a third one. If you see it. Hopefully I'm making sense on that and not just boring you with this stuff. Okay, so any other comments? How long would this take in you if you didn't have 250 people watching? Yeah, it would certainly be quicker. I mean, it's not hugely quicker because I take breaks to come back to things, but it's a fair bit quicker than this. So I won't be billing them for this this many hours. Sammy's still watching, is he? Tell him it took me 10 hours. Anyway, but obviously I don't do that. We're much quicker. Without people watching and chatting away, it's quite fun like this, doing this sort of fun, and I probably wouldn't be going backwards showing people aspects of what I'm doing. Good night, Anish Waggle. So new people joining, some people leaving. Do remember you can catch the whole stream. I'll upload it obviously to my channel afterwards. In fact, I'll put it in the live stream playlist. Is the best way. Okay, so I want to duplicate this, so I'll move this to a collection. New collect. In fact, let's duplicate it first. That's a stupid idea. Duplicate it first, and then I will move this one to a new collection, which is, I often call it spares, if I could spell it, spares. Because then I can go back, if I mess this up in any way, I can just quickly go back, or I can even just grab objects from here and then move them in if I need to. So, like and sub to Grant Abbott. Yes, indeed. Like and subscribe. Right, so let's hide that collection now. So spares, there it is. And is it worth moving this into a collection? Probably is. The light and camera, I always like to move to a collection as well. So let's grab those and move to a collection. New to collection, light cam. So I can put those out of the way as well and be a bit more organized. Okay, so at this point, I'm going to start applying the mirror modifier and stuff like that. And then I'm going to unwrap. So I'm going to do some UV unwrapping. And I might have to finish about 6 o'clock. We'll see. We'll see how we go. Vegetable Hulk. I'm not sure what that's about. I thought the object should look more like the drawing. No, they're giving me poetic license. I should be fine there. I might even prop one side up and have something sticking out, is one of my thoughts. I suppose I ought to do that now if I'm going to. Let's apply the mirrors first and then start seeing what it looks like. Can you try making the whole bag a bit taller? Let's try that. Obviously, I'd do the buckles again. In fact, let's just do that with the bag. Is that looking nicer? Let me know. Taller, smaller. What do people say? I'll wait a moment. squish the bag thinner, maybe. In fact, as people were saying there, so maybe the taller is better. Your voice is excellent, your accent too. Thank you. Yorkshire. I think my accent is British type now. Oh, so you've lived in Yorkshire for a while. taller is more backpack. I like it taller. This is interesting. It's fascinating having a whole team of 270 people telling me what to do. This is brilliant. Tall is good, but too rounded on top. Yeah, you're probably right there. It looks a bit like it's got a bald head or something. It looks weird. That could be the put an anti-material rifle in the bag just for Anti-material? Not heard of that one. Seams, plumber, taller is good. Plumber. Fat is more stylized. You see, that's... I'm going to go undo and redo. Undo, redo. Do you know, I'm thinking the taller might be better. Let's bring this down then. Grab Z. It's looking closer to this now, isn't it? Which I sort of didn't want it, but if that's what people are after, then that's cool. I'm happy with that. Yeah, so what are other people saying? Definitely flatter. We'll make the back. I'll make the back a bit better in a second. A handle on the top. Yeah, I think we're going too far there. And I'm trying to, I'm a bit rushed for time, but don't fat shame the back. You fatty. that's a guess it's hard for you to move forward, but it's still great for us to see you in action. I'm glad you're still enjoying it, and it looks like people are enjoying it with 280. Let me know if I'm going too slowly, though. I do worry about that a bit. I'm having loads of fun. Yellow border needs to be fatter. I think you are right. I was thinking that myself. So I'm going to select these ones here because the bottom already seems to be a bit fatter. Grab in the X, move them in just a touch. Maybe that's, is that too far? Tough to know. I need my team of experts instantly telling me. How's that? I like it. I'm liking this. Good get. Brand it a Gucci bag. Yep, I'll write that on here. Seeing some of these silly comments. Will the stream be on YouTube as videos? Well, yes, indeed it will. A little slow for me, but not too bad. Okay, yep. I appreciate people being honest as well. That helps. I need to improve and need to know what I'm doing in future episodes. Okay, so let's carry on. I better copy this. I've got my spares over here. Probably don't need to. I'll probably be right. So let's. So I'm going to apply the mirror. I'm just thinking, do I need to apply the mirror now? Yes, I do. Just I'm seeing what people are saying. I'll draw some buttons on, certainly. I think I'm going to go with this. Thanks for all the extra comments. That's helpful. I do feel like these buckles need to go down a little bit, though. Just a little bit. There we go. Let's grab that top bit. Notice how I'm overlapping some of these shapes. That's absolutely fine when you're hand painting and there's no animation. YouTube is not receiving enough video to maintain smooth streaming. Are people noticing a glitch? Or are we okay? Just let me know if we're all okay. That's strange. More info. I'm just going to quickly check this with what's going on. And the more info is exactly the same as the info I'm given. Any problems, anybody? Let me know. So the stream's taken a hit. Only for a few seconds. Are we okay now? It's my annoying internet. I'm hoping that I can sort that out. But yeah, it's getting to that busy time, you see, where people are coming back from work. This is sort of happening. Oh, glad to hear you enjoyed the podcast. Yep, there's a podcast where me, Ducky, CG Matter, Curtis, Holt, and Blender Binge. I feel like I'm missing someone there. We all, and Shotty, can't remember. We all got together and did a podcast. And we're planning on doing that every Sunday, actually. But I'm not sure how. Regular that really will be, but we'll try our best. That'll be good fun. We're all fine streaming now. That's great. We need to move on because I've only got a small time left, but I want to get to the unwrapping so I can talk about that and get that shape sorted. So let's apply the mirror on here. I mean, do I need to make another copy? I'm just going to quickly, I'll save it, Control S and Shift D X and just put that over there and not go to it much. Okay, I'm going to move it into a new collection. I can't help myself but organize. Spares too. And hide that. Okay, so let's come in here and apply things. I'm sort of being more nervous about applying things and stuff that I would normally, probably because I don't want to make a mistake, which is a bit weird. The podcast what's the channel called? It's called Blender Nest. Yeah, Blender Nest. Have a look at that. Look it up. It should appear, hopefully, all going well. So I've applied that mirror. Always apply from the top downwards when you're applying modifiers. So now I can go in and tidy the back up. But to be honest, it's not really going to be seen much. So I might leave it as it is there. It's going to be seen from about this angle, the same as this. I mean, it'd be nice that I can move it around a bit as I see fit, but I probably won't see from the side. So in that case, I don't really need to paint the back and don't need to worry about it. Grant and CG matter, Grant matter. So the podcast is Blender Nest. If you search for that on YouTube, I'll put a link in the description eventually, and hopefully you'll be able to find it from there. Is it looking too fat though? I mean, is this all right? I feel like it's okay. I quite like it. Right, so I've done that. I won't apply the mirrors to these. Actually, I'm going to apply the solidify to these ones. Yep, so what am I doing? There we go. So I've applied that, and I'll apply these, and I'll apply this. So that's everything, isn't it? All the objects. Now, also, I'm going to select all, control A, and now set the scale. Hopefully, I won't regret doing that. And let's just quickly go in and add a bit of character. So I'll do this in X-ray mode so that I can... You're not going to be able to see it very well. What I'll do is I'll... Oh, no. That's where my face is. Let's get rid of this now. So you can see it in normal mode, and I can see it in X-ray and grab bits and pieces. I'm going to turn on proportional editing and vertex mode and select things and move them around a bit. So just giving it, hopefully, a bit of character. When I'm doing these bottom ones, I'm pressing G, then Shift Z, so I'm not moving it in the Z axis because I don't really want it to go below the floor and have to sort of sort that out, if that makes sense. So already I think it's got a bit more character. Can you see that? That looks quite fun, really. I mean, I'll have to change the straps and things in a second. That's no problem, though. Vertices in the top, front, middle. I'm not sure your point, Soul Skinner. What are you saying? I think they should be a bit more round. Okay, let's have a look. I mean, it's just not got a lot of shape there. I don't think I'm too worried. I think, maybe you're right. Let's sort of flatten it down a little bit there. That I quite like that sort of shape, actually. Gives it sort of natural look. It's a little bit warped, cartoony style. Let me know what you think. Works for me. I think use lattices. I mean, I could use a lattice, but I prefer... I can't get as much pulling around with a lattice, but I could have done. Backpack from Dora, but in a fantasy genre. Yeah, I hadn't thought about that. Dora the Explorer backpack. That's a good point. I ought to have used that perhaps as a reference as well. Just moving these around a touch more. I feel like I could have... used a bit more of a cut in here, but I think it's okay. Just having a quick look around here as well. You all can see that. Yeah, I'm just checking we're good. I'm still impressed that 288 people are watching. That's great. I was talking about these ones. Not sure which ones you mean. Sorry. Grant is awesome. Yes, he is indeed, isn't he? I think rounding it the other way. Not sure. I think about there is where I want to view it from. And I think that looks good at the moment. Looks like a mushroom house now. Mochila. I'm not sure what that means. But now it looks good. Wait, is this the backpack for Dora in Atlas Empires? No, it isn't. the new slant is tight. I like it. Good. Yeah, that's cool. So let's start moving the buckles now. Back out of X-ray mode because that's awkward. And let's just, oh, of course they're attached, aren't they? I need to In order to separate, into edit mode, select all P for separate, or separate, and then by loose parts. And now they are separate objects. And I should just be able to rotate this a bit. Rotate in the Z. And grab in the Y. That should just come out there. Let's just click away, make sure we got that looking okay. That looks good. This one looks okay anyway. But now I want to do a little bit of... Oh, I've got to separate this one as well. And this one. Can I do both of them in edit mode? This would be interesting. P by loose parts. Yes, I can. Oh, that's quite clever, Blender. I'm quite impressed. Where were we? Alex Lawrence, thank you that you're enjoying it. And it's nice to see me live. Make the bottom a bit wider. Yeah, could be. I like it. Let's just go into there. Still on proportional editing, so grab Shift Z. I'm not sure. I'm maybe not quite seeing what you're saying actually, but maybe I'm not sure that's working for me now. Let's grab this. I'll grab both of these. Grab Shift Z. I'm gonna undo that. Grab Shift Z and pull it out a little bit. I'm starting to feel like maybe it needs this section in a bit more like this. I'm sort of using this as my reference point. I might come back to that. Thank you for my vids being sick. I wish we could send images here. Yeah, I wish you could as well. I suppose it's not a great platform for it, is it? But I suppose the thing for me is that I get a bit of advertising revenue, so it's helpful for me and my channel. I'm thinking of buying a new microphone, so I'm looking to use the funds that I have accrued from this channel in order to buy a nice microphone, so I'll have a really deep presenter voice like this, hopefully. We'll see how we get on. A map would look cool. Yeah, I'm thinking that map needs to come out of there, doesn't it? What I might do is nick the scroll from the other one and then just stick that out, and then I don't need to worry about making that. And it's something I'll probably add in afterwards with a bit of creative license. Scale the edge loop just under the buckle, out the smidge. This one. Outwards, you think? Let's try it. Actually, you know, I'm kind of liking that. Oh, I just spat on my... on my keyboard. What are people thinking? Do your highest pitch voice. I don't know whether that'd be suitable for the stream. is that good? Do you enjoy that? Don't do requests. I don't know much about Twitch to try it. What do people think of this sort of fatter bottom like this? I think I quite like it. Yeah, it looks better. There we go. People are liking it. Well, three people. let me know, people. Let me know. Because it makes a big difference. Just try drag the pockets out, make them look more rounder, better. Can you tell my friend James he's stupid? I wouldn't say that to James. He's a lovely chap, I'm sure. The middle bottom part needs to be more wider. This middle bottom part, or this middle bottom part. So here, do we need another loop cut? I'm going away from the low poly feeling though if I do that, but let's see. I'm just gonna change the circle of influence. You see what I'm doing there? Do you know, it does look cool though, doesn't it? We're having fun, aren't we? Does this pocket need to come out this way a bit? Oh, gee, that way. I'm just, there we go. Maybe, I'm not sure. This one looks a bit odd though. It's looking kind of cool. I do need to work on the straps. Yeah, the belt needs to sort of stick out. The belt straps coming out here. We look too fat.
Too fat.
Are you fattest? It's quite nice, loving it. Now it looks too. Now it looks fat. Everybody's out. Fattists. You mean fattists. Let's scale this in again here. Is that helping? We'll definitely come to the painting soon, Kevin. I haven't got long. I was hoping to go to Way Too Fat Now, and that that's been blocked. It's one massive backpack. I suppose that's true. It's looking more like a bag, but is that working? A bit too much, maybe. Okay, let's. Looks like a house. You're being very rude about its fatness. Let's scale it in a bit. Let's have a look. Is that better? I'm just testing things out a little bit. See you later, Sheila. More organic. That's what I'm going for. Let's move the straps and the buckles and see what happens. So this strap, for example, I should have kept this with the solidifier actually and just applied the mirror. That was silly of me, wasn't it? See, that's the mistakes I often make are like that. So typical mistakes, applying the mirror too early. It's a classic for me. But we got away with it this time by the looks of things. So I just pull that out. Oop, that's pulling it in. And maybe the strap needs to sort of curl up a bit as well. Shall I be naughty and add another loop cut in here for the strap? So it sort of curves up a bit more. Again, we're moving away from the low poly, but it's looking kind of cool, isn't it? The center line of the side pockets could come out a bit more and to give it a bit of an appearance of something in it. Oh, the side pockets, I see what you mean. Yeah, that's probably true. Let's get these two. In fact, these two faces I think would be better, wouldn't it? How about there? Maybe about here. So undo, redo, undo, redo. I think the redo. Maybe just a slightly in between, about there. Yep, I agree. That's good. This is taking much longer than I thought, but we are. I feel like it's looking good though. So I'm appreciating a lot of this help. It's quite fun. But yeah, this was. Generally, these things take me about 3 to 4 hours in total, and that's things like getting the reference images and all that sort of stuff as well. So I've gone way over the time because this whole stream is 2 hours and I haven't even finished the modeling. But I could always use it as a portfolio piece, can I? That's the thing. So sometimes a project will take longer than you think, but if you try and do everything to the best of your ability, then you've got your portfolio getting better and better all the time. Copy the straps and buckles from the previous bag. Yeah, I could do that. It seems to be working all right though, so I'm not too worried about the the problem with the grabbing the straps, if you know what I mean. Hopefully that makes sense. My ramblings there. So I rotate that a bit, grab it this way. It's just coming through a bit there. So I'm just doing this by hand. It's with a proportional edit. It's a bit like sculpting, isn't it? And it's doing okay. That's what it's looking like over here. It's looking pretty cool. I feel like this one needs to go sort of the other way up. So it's going to rotate this way. Come out a bit there. Should have rotated the whole thing really. A bit like this. And maybe this can come out this way a little bit. So it's got a bit of a, like the, you know, when the leather sort of gets older, it sort of cracks and chaps a bit, that sort of thing. I'm not going to animate it, no. It won't be attached to a character or anything. Still got one strap. Yep, doing that now, that's good. I probably need to bring up the top a little bit though, don't I? Grab that there. And these ones. I'm just doing it by eye. I'm assuming I know where these bits and pieces are. Let's grab that. And this one here. Sort of grabbing through the model. I think we're all okay for the straps and things. Oh, there's something, a slight glitch in this one. Can you see? Oh, what's happened there? Do you know, I've no idea what's happened there, so I'm actually going to have to isolate that. And, I see what's going on. So, G, that's really odd, isn't it? Looks like a face is overlapping another face. Oh, that was the bevel I did, wasn't it? Now, that's weird. Okay, what I can do then is just, I'll come out of proportional edit, I think, and we'll do some edge sliding, get it back into place. There we go, it's pretty much there. And then these two, J to join. I forgot, yeah, bevel sometimes overlaps itself. You can't, there's a clamp setting you can put on, but I didn't notice it was doing that. But I think we're fine now, and we don't need to worry about that triangle there. I'm just going to move some of these across with proportional edit on now. Press O, shortcut for proportional edit. And in here. This is good. I'm going to bevel this one as well. And so we can actually see what happened there. So Control B. Oh, no, sorry. There we go, Control B. See, it works fine on here. What happened to the other one then? And let's bring the other stuff back now. Oh no, look, it's the other side that's doing it. But it doesn't make too much difference, it's all right. Okay, so that's looking pretty good. I feel like there's a little bit of a glitch over here. Not much one there, but let's just bring that back out. Proportional edit off, G this way, there we go. Let's just check everything's good. Hi, Abbott, hello. It was the bevel, indeed it was, yes. The stream is 2 hours and we're still on the modelling. Yeah, typical modelling progress. It's usually much faster than this, I must say. Well, I say much faster. It usually takes me an hour for the modelling and a couple of hours for the painting, about that. And just general sort of hour long in between doing bits and pieces, finding reference images and all this sort of stuff. Thanks, guy. How do you go into local view? /forward on your numpad. Is that coming up on the... Yeah, numpad /. If you don't have /, how anybody know how to do it without a numpad? Not sure. So /on your numpad. Cool stream, thank you. We're up to 287. Are we going to break 300? Who knows? What we need is a map and a sword. Oh, a sword would be kind of cool, wouldn't it? Your beard looks good, thank you. I think it looks better on camera than in real life, to be honest. It's a little bit scratchy at the moment. Laziness is my problem. A bit thinner backpack, lol, joking, looks nice. shall I get the map from the other file and see how that's going to look? Because I think it's going to look cool. Oh, where's my mouse gone? What's going on? There you go. Let's try that. Let's go back out of isolation mode is what I'm trying to say. File. Let's save it. Saver works. Save as... And let's add that in. And let's file append. Okay, so up we go. And what was it? It was the inventory. No, it wasn't. I'm doing the inventory at the moment. It was the learn, I think, learn icon. And let's try the last one. Let's go in there. Object. I didn't name these objects, so that's poor show. It's probably going to be a cylinder, though, isn't it? The others, yep, so we'll do that. We'll bring those all in. You can see all these objects. Oh, weirdly, it didn't come in. File append. God, it always ends up, even though I bring it over here, you would have thought it would end up on the same screen, that new file thing. These cylinder. Oh, I didn't get that cylinder, so it probably is this cylinder here, isn't it? Let's try that once more. There it is. There is my map. Will the text just come through? I can't remember now. Yes, they do. Oh, look at that. Beautiful stuff. Hand-painted to perfection, honestly, Governor. Right, so let's top view. Let's just move that into position. Front view, move it down. And it's a little bit big. So just creeping out there. And full stop to center my camera again. And let's just bring it backwards to there. Rotate it around. Again, low poly work. If this were for a game, I would cut this here, make sure it didn't overlap too much and all that sort of stuff. I've got to rotate it round. In fact, I should have done that. Rotate Z, and let's rotate it around the other way and up this way. Because can you see I haven't really painted that half because it was an icon again. Naughty Grant. That's probably a good reason why you should complete your models in case they suddenly say, oh, can we have it from this angle? So I was trusting that they wouldn't say that. Okay, so we've got that coming out there. I think that looks kind of cool. Don't know about you guys. It's looking pretty cool. Any thoughts? That's just a habit sort of, oh, yeah, that's holding my head. No, my head is all right. I haven't banged it or anything. I wish you luck, the Art Kid, with your Pokemon thing you're going to do. Unleash 75. The new window opening on your main screen must be something related to save startup file. Could be actually, couldn't it? Does Dora the Explorer have exactly that? I'm going to have to look up and just check that Dora the Explorer, because I only know of it. Let's press Control at some point. No, that's all right. I'm safe. There isn't a backpack. Let's just put backpack. I don't want to copy Dora the Explorer, so everybody who looks at Atlas Empire says, "Oh, it's just like Dora the Explorer." They've got some weird things sticking out. I don't know what that is. Oh, it is. Oh, no. It's a little map. We're okay. We're all right. I think that's in the side pocket. Ours is in sticking out of our bag, so I think that's cool. What do other people think? Actually, looks awesome. Looks great. The map needs to pop out both sides, do you think? Oh, I see. So I feel like this is a bit sort of rougher. What do other people think? Bingit. What's Bingit? is it that instead of Googling it? Where are you finding some order like making this low poly model? I'm not sure what you mean. So let me know if this is okay. Is it looking all right? It's reporting it to the Dora creator. It's close to the Tomb Raider backpack. That's more like it. That's more like our style. We can handle that. Here, I'm scratching my head again. Both sides doesn't work, so you're agreeing with me there. I like it the way it is. It'll be an FBX for the game, and I can show you that process if you're interested. But to be fair, I won't be exporting this model. Yeah, do I need a hole? I will paint a hole in. I'll paint all that area in. So this will be just a really dark paint. Yeah. The map. Hello from Germany, crypto. Wouldn't the map be stretched when it's stuffed into the bag? Yep, there's going to be a sort of gap there. So this will come up and down. That's what I'm thinking. Do others agree? Maybe the top of the bag. God damn, I'm spending ages on this modeling, aren't I? It needs to come down a bit like this. So it's sort of stuffed in like that, perhaps. But yeah, I will paint that section in. Google some Tomb Raider. What about auto smooth? No, don't need auto smooth. When you paint the model, your highlights make it look like it's got the edges it needs. Why would you cut the map and connect? So it's got inside faces. So if I go to wireframe, you can see that all this is inside faces that we don't need to see, because we'll just see the edge here. So yes, I could model all this, but we can do it by eye in the way we paint. I don't know how to paint in Blender, so I can't wait to see how it is. Not squished, sorry, but maybe flatter. Yeah, oh, from the bag, I see what you mean. Yeah. Let's have a look. Solid. Let's go to render mode, actually, see what the... Oh, no, actually not rendered, Eevee mode. And we'll scale in Z. So it's a little bit flatter. Is that looking better? Probably is. So undo... Redo, yes, I think you're right. Yep. PM Toons, good night. I will be a regular viewer after 4 to 5 months. rotate the map a bit more. It looks like it's touching the bottom of the bag. So it looks like, oh, I see, like this. Does that work? Maybe. Coming out of a hidden pocket. I like it. I mean, there could even be two maps there, because they could be... I'll just try. Don't panic. It might be a bad idea, but let's scale that one down and rotate in the local Y. No, the local Z then. And they look like bones at the moment, don't they? Is that better? I'm going to turn this view to... well, I'm not so sure, actually. Any thoughts? How often do you stream? It's turning out to be once a week at the moment, but too thick, yeah, maybe. Panics. Two maps might be better composition-wise, but are they better? Maybe. I mean, we can easily move the maps around to the shape that we need. And the bag part a little bit lifted because it packs into it. So this section here, I think you mean, don't you? So let's just grab that and that one there. And let's grab that up a little bit more. I'm actually going to grab it off to the side here as well. I think this is working out nicely. It's looking pretty fun. I mean, I'm going way overboard on this. Rotate the second scroll down in its local Z axis. The local z-axis for this is, if I the zz is that way. Do you mean that way around? I mean, I haven't painted that side much. Maybe you're right. So it goes there. Yep. Hello, Interpixel. Binge watching the channel. That's nice. Yeah, that's really nice. We take one of them so they don't align with the ends so much. Yeah. So a bit more. Perhaps like that. Yep, that's cool. Just having a look at what people are saying. Yep, that's great. Okay, so last thing I'll do today, and then I'll do another stream tomorrow. I'm just thinking when I can stream tomorrow. Which would people prefer? Would you prefer... I'm thinking I could probably do a stream around between 2 and 4, or maybe 4 and 6 like today. What do people think? I can't really do it in the evening tomorrow, I don't think, because the internet tends to just struggle, unfortunately. Really appreciate the content. Thank you to Kagu. Tukakagu? I'm not sure, but thank you. Swirly snail eyes? What's that about? Is that my eyes, is it? I have to go cook now for my girlfriend. It's good stuff, Dr. Fine Mind. Thank you very much for joining us. Between 4 and 6, like today, 4 and 6, 4 and 6. So 2 and 4 is there's one for 2 and 4. Can I stream a bit earlier? So that's, we've got half and half at the moment. Thanks again, Grant. 4 and 6. A bit too late. Okay, so it could go either way by the looks of things. Maybe 3 and 5. Would that be better for people? Put 3 and 5 if that helps. I will do some unwrapping in a second. 4 and 6. Most people are 4 and 6. Thanks for the stream. Mahmoud Ali is going to... do my dishes for a year. Thank you very much. I'll the link affiliated in the description. Yeah, so if it's to do with... If there are links to other things, then yes, there is affiliated links. So things to graphics tablets and stuff. Yes, they are. Oh, 3 to 5 people may be preferring, actually. 3 to 5. Okay. Looks like 3 to 5. Wow, lots of people. Interpixel. Hello, Interpixel. Oh, hang on. That's all from Interpixel. Oh, pain. You fooled me there. I was just reading it thinking, yeah, there's loads of people. 24/7. Okay, so I'm, what time is it? What time is it now? For me is, sorry, excuse me, yeah, 6 o'clock now for me. So 3 to 5 would be an hour before this one was. It's a good point, actually, yeah. So this one was 4 to 6 for me. So would people like it this time? Yeah. I'll look back at that in a second. Yes, Interpixel. Okay, so just quickly then, let's go back to solid mode. It's easy to see for unwrapping. I'm actually going to make this this and this an instant of each other. So as in, what do you call it? A linked duplicate sort of thing. So Control L will link them together, and then you press Object Data. Let's undo that because it disappeared. So the reason it disappeared is probably because I need to set the scale and rotation. So set all transforms, probably these, rotation scale. Let's do that. And now set the rotation scale for this as well. So it's Control A, rotation scale. And now if I press them and press Control L, object data. Oh, now that is interesting. That shouldn't have happened, should it? Why is that happening? I'm a bit confused there, actually. Ah, that's because they share the same center point. Aha. So when I mirrored and then I separated them, the center point, the pivot point, is in the middle there. So I need to set this one, set origin to geometry. There we go. Now I should be able to Control L, object data. And it's copied the rotation as well. I'm surprised it did that. But still, we can put it back into position. Of course it did because I set it. There we go. So R and Z, let's put that into position. Now I only need to paint one, and then once I've painted one, I can then, if I need to, bake it and change it around if I have to. This strap is sticking out a bit that way, so grab in the Y. Let's just tidy that up a little bit before I unwrap. Okay, and this one and this one, I would say that's a good idea for them to be object instance. So I'll right-click on this one, set origin to geometry, Select on both, Control A and set the scale. Maybe I can get away without the location. So Control L, object data. No, I can't, it's still rotating. So rotate Z to make it go back. But having a little bit of a different buckle there. I suppose actually because I want them to paint them the same, they need to be pretty much the same. So otherwise the shading will be out. So just looking, so 3 to 5. Lots of people telling me the time, where they are. That's cool. So many, it's just so weird, isn't it? It being around the world and it being nighttime somewhere or the morning somewhere else. It's just fascinating to me. I don't know why it's so fascinating. So I'm hoping it's probably going to be 3 to 5 because that's actually the best for me, I believe. I'm not absolutely positive on that one yet. It might have to be the 2 to 4 or 4 to 6. We'll see. We'll see how we go. So what are these models for? It's a game called Atlas Empires that I'm making, but this is actually only for the icon. So I'm going a little bit high poly, more high poly than I would if this were for game. So little aspects like this would probably be painted on, really. So that's worth mentioning again then. So let's go across our model just quickly. Thinking of places to unwrap, obvious places are where there are natural seams. So in here, there's a natural seam. So I'm just shift left clicking around the place. Going all the way around, up in here as well, all the way around. Alt left click would make more sense. And in fact, why am I doing it like that? You can also press Control, can't you? But let's just go to there. Control E for the edge menu, and then mark seams is down here. So there's one thing unwrapped there. I think it's probably best. I mean, at the back, it doesn't matter too much. So I'm going to get rid. So do an unwrap around here. Again, when you're painting, you don't have to worry too much about the unwrap. You can get away with an awful lot. So let's mark seams there. And Alt left click on that one, mark seams. I'm just going around the bottom now, mark seams. So I'm doing this fairly fast. Hopefully that's okay. Do shout if you've got any questions. Is there a quick way to overlay islands without actually linking objects? Actually, not that I know of. I mean, you can obviously do it by eye, but they might unwrap slightly different if they're not linked. It's a good question, that, actually. Maybe someone else knows. Anybody else know? Is there a way to overlap islands if they're not linked? So going around, marking seams. Oh, I missed the bottom there. Control E, mark seam. Just by eye at the moment, thinking where would there be a seam? And just from my experience as well as to knowing what's going to stretch and what's not. So this should all be all right. This section here, that's all good. Oh, I have to do it around here as well. So Alt left click and the bottom here as well. Control E mark seams. And yeah, but down the bottom here. And up there, Control E mark seams. So that should be okay. Let's take a look. So let's go to the UV editing space. This is going to mess up my screen a bit. I'm just going to see how I can get on with my face being up there. Can't see me at the moment. I need to get OBS back up. Let me just see. Okay, that should be okay. I don't think I'm covering anything up too much. Should be all right. Okay, so where's my mouse gone? There it is. So select all. Let's try that again. I haven't stopped streaming or something because I was pressing buttons in OBS there. I tried the buckle there, just having a look through. Yeah, smart UV unwrap would have probably been okay actually, but I like to be absolutely sure. It can cause glitches quite often if you've got a very detailed model, so probably wouldn't be a problem here. Let's do that. Smart UV project, and I always turn the margin up to about 0.6, and that's a pretty good unwrap, isn't it? I'll go full screen on that so you can sort of see it a bit better, but it's not too bad. But what I find is, like the smart UV project, why is that not 6 pixels like it said it was going to be? And that happens quite often. I mean, even if I go to UV, pack islands, oh, my thing's not coming up, there it is. But we've got 6 pixels there and it's not doing it for some reason, don't understand. So I find the smart UV project is still a bit of a pain. Maybe that's a glitch in 2.8. See you later, Interpixel. Texture Atlas, yeah, they're useful plugins. I've used Texture Atlas and I found it quite awkward to use, but it was helpful. So I select all again, unwrap, and just unwrap normally this time. So now, Let's go to this again, and I'm going to put 0.6 in here. And can you see how they moved that time? So that is a bit better. And let's just have a quick look around. I think I can move, go to the islands, and it would make sense to move these in here just for the sake of using the space. Again, I don't have to worry too much. I probably could have unwrapped there as well, but that's coming out okay. I might as well just move them around a bit just so they've got a nice bit of space in between each of them. Yep, this one up. I might rotate that one 90 degrees, move that up, and just give them all a nice bit of breathing space. So I'm going to get no overlapping of pixels. If they overlap like this, when I paint one area, it's going to paint on the other one as well. And that's a big pain. It does happen more than you think. I've learned my lesson. Island margin is the other field. Was I pressing the wrong island margin there, was I? No, wasn't doing that, was I? Maybe that's why. Oh, no. What is the concept of UV unwrapping? So if you think of a t-shirt, it comes from one piece of material. So you've got to consider that as your 2D material that you're trying to place onto your 3D object. And if you just go chuck this 2D image onto this 3D object, it doesn't know where to put different parts of it. So UV unwrapping is the process of that. So it's like, and seams are literally like they are in clothing. So when you do a t-shirt, you actually sort of draw a flat t-shirt and you have two halves and you seam them together. And the 3D model can be the same. So you've got a sort of seam down the middle in the same way as this has a seam down here and you stitch them together. So this is the flat version of my 3D model. And that's what the texture, that's these bits are where the texture is going to appear. Hopefully that sums it up reasonably well. When you move stuff around to get more space, would it not be better to make the texture face smaller, or doesn't that matter to fill size? The texture space. So we want to fill this space up as much as possible. That's the main thing. So, I mean, I could rotate this and scale it up a bit, and that's using the space better. What you can't do is scale in the Y, because that would just cause stretching and it doesn't help in the way you draw things and stuff. So you don't scale disproportionately. But we are trying to, in fact, yeah, rotate 90. Let's scale this one up a little bit more. So I'm using a bit more of the texture space there. So these blank areas are a waste of space, and therefore, if you're doing it in game, that's going to cause you slight, well, not, it's just performance issues. It's not a massive thing, but when it comes to mobile games, it becomes a bit bigger. It's like making a 3D image from a piece of paper, so with no overlapping, exactly that. Okay, so we've done the bag, and I'll do a separate texture for a bag, a separate texture for the buckles, and I suppose I'll put the buckles together, because this is how you'd normally do it, so no problem. It's wasted data, indeed it is. So I'll put these all together. That's a linked object, isn't it? Yeah, so this, and these two, because these are sharing the same texture space as those, because they are linked duplicates. And we want to unwrap these. I'll just quickly do a smart UV project and see what it looks like. So let's go into edit mode, select all, and U to unwrap. The smart UV project. And no, it was the island weight. Oh, island weight. Area weight. Oh no, you're right. Just pretend that that didn't happen earlier. Okay, let's try turn this margin up. Is it working this time? Yeah, no, it does still have a problem. Look, in here, that's really close compared to the island margin here. So the live unwrap there is a bit of a pain. But the one thing we can do with this live unwrap, with more islands like this, we could spread them out better in a more precise way. There's a really good add-on for this, Pack Master add-on, I think it's called. That will pack them all in really cleverly and make it really tight. The weird thing is I actually quite like having a bit of space just in case I want to add an object somewhere or do something like that. So generally that's an okay unwrap, and it's doing a good job. There's lots of tiny objects, and even this one, it's almost like it's overlapped. So we can move all these tiny objects around. But generally, I prefer doing a proper unwrap. So I'm going to quickly, very quickly do that, hopefully. So on this buckle, an easy way to do the buckle is going to be this one and the inside one. Let's isolate that, forward slash on the numpad. And that one, Control E, mark seams. And that should work all right. Back out of isolation mode. This one, the actual buckle itself, just having a look, making sure that's the same on both sides. Do you know, that's such a small object, I'm going to unlink it. The way you unlink objects, I've got a shortcut. Actually, how do you unlink? Do you know, I've got set my shortcut up under object data properties or something, isn't it? Not convert to parent, is it? I'm trying to remember. Relationships, that's it. Relations, make single user, that's it. And object data. So now they aren't linked. So you'll see they aren't linked because I'll select. They are still linked. Oh, that didn't work, did it? Object, I'm sure that's how we do it. Did I just do it to another object there? Relations, make single user, object data. Oh, I missed this menu, selected object. There we go. Now, yeah, now we can see it's not affecting the other one. I'm going to make them separate objects because I think it will be better. I think it'll just make more sense. I'm not sure that individual scaling is a good idea. It can make seams visible. I haven't noticed that myself. That's interesting. Yes, seam is cutting the paper to fit. Yep. What is the island margin for? That's a good point. I'll show you in a second, Diana. And you should be able to make stretching visible at least. That's the case in 2.79. Yes, you can still make stretching visible. It is in one of the options. I can't remember quite where it is. Okay, just having a look, making sure everything's still working okay. I've gone on a bit of extra time this time, long stream this one. But just to finish this, so quickly unwrap this. So isolation mode again. Let's grab this edge around here, Control E mark seam, and this one around here, Control E mark seam. That's absolutely fine. I suppose, to be honest, I could do, in fact, I don't even need this face at the back here. So I'll show you what I mean. That's what I mean by deleting stuff you don't need. So we don't see it, so delete it. Same with this one, because it's not a link duplicate anymore, so I'm going to have to do the same. I can just select a face and Control E mark seam, and that will do all the face, the edges connected to that face. Notice this is an N-gon, and I'm not worried about it. It's flat, so it's not going to make much difference. I'll delete that back face. Okay, so I've unwrapped those. It's just the straps to go. So Alt in edge mode, Alt right click, all the way around here. I'll isolate that actually, that'll be better. And I'll do it at the edges here as well. Back face also. So we've got all those round edges. That's a bit weird, isn't it? We don't really need that, but that's not going to be a problem and it's not going to cause performance issues or anything silly like that. So Control E, mark seams. And then lastly, the other one. And then we'll be ready for painting, which I'll do tomorrow. Probably between 3 and 5. It's going to be roughly around there, all going well. Looking forward to it already. I love the painting, but I may not get it finished in that time, to be honest. Especially as I'm chatting away. But then having said that, I'll probably be able to chat and draw at the same time without too much fuss. Whereas modelling, you have to think a bit more, don't you? That's why I don't like modelling. You have to think. Oh, I'm being silly now, aren't I? Get that in there. I mean, that is awful topology. But let's not worry about it. Control E, mark seams. I'm going to tidy that up because that, GG, there we go. We do not need that. Okay, so, right, so let's go out of isolation mode. And I did say we're doing these together. So this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one. There we go. The buckles are the same. So if I go into edit mode now, yep, that's fine. So U to unwrap. And here we go. It's done such a dreadful job packing these, hasn't it? Let's grab that over here. I'm going to grab these. Can you select objects and then do packing? Pack islands. Yes, you can. So now I can try and reorganize them a bit. There's the pack island thing. Can I find a space for this one now, though? I mean, I probably can, because you can adjust these slightly. So let's go to vertex mode and grab those vertex. Vertex? Those vertices. I'm just moving these by hand and straightening them up. There's conformal and other things that you can do, but I'm just quickly do this by hand, just straighten that up, and then straighten these up. There shouldn't be too much stretching doing this, so that should be fine. Back to island mode, so I can select different options. You've got vertices, edges, and faces, but you've also got islands, so these are called islands. Oh yes, I was gonna say, wasn't I? What was the question again? Oh, sorry, I've forgotten the question. Where is it? Where's the question? Island margin. So the island margin, yep, is the distance between the islands. So you can see that the distance here is nice and big, so I'm not going to paint on this one and it overlap. And when they're really tight, like this, you might see the seams. So you try and have a reasonable island margin. I'm just putting these into places which are, have a bit of space around them. So you try and have a reasonable island margin to give yourself that bit of extra space and make it comfortable to, so you don't get visible seams and so forth. There we go, that one up there. Oh, I thought I'd move this one. There we go. And that's a nice pack, to be honest, because I do always worry a little bit about going so close to the edge, so I always like to bring them in, but I think that's just my brain not allowing it and being unhappy about something going wrong, but I think it's absolutely fine to go to the edge. I don't think that causes any errors, really. Can't help myself but to move them around then. Okay, so there we go. We have unwrapped. So the unwrap, that's a good point. I didn't say that, did I? So the difference between the unwrap and the smart UV project, when you smart UV project, it just thinks, oh, there probably should be a seam here, there probably should be a bit seam here, and then unwraps it the best it can with its own sort of islands. If I go around and mark the seams, I can tell it exactly where I want those islands to be, and they'll come up. And I think you'd probably admit that this is a bit better as an unwrap than the smart UV project was. Okay. Okay, so that's as far as I'm going to go with the model. Any other questions? I'm happy to sort of stick around for a few more questions. Thanks very much for joining me. This is really good fun, as always. It's time for tea at 5. Yeah, that is exactly it. It will probably go on a little bit longer. I'll probably go 3 till 5:30 or something like that. Like today is 4 till 6:30 pretty much. But this is looking a nice little model. It's good fun, this was. The back end, obviously, I would tidy up if I were doing it properly, but we're only going to see it from this half, definitely, so we don't need to do that. So I'll save my work. I better save my work, can I? Save as. And at this point, what I'd like to do, so obviously these are the modeling stage. I put a little plus one, so it's in 5, but then I'll say ready for paint. Then I've got sort of blocks that I can go back to in my saved work. Looks great, thank you very much. You don't really need the back faces or the straps, and as another person said, you only need to seam the corners then. Not sure what you mean there, actually. Could be right. I might have gone overboard in what I've done here. If you were to use different values for the single face you're painting on, could you not reduce your poly count? If you were to use different values for the single face you're painting on? I'm not sure. I'm not sure what you mean. Sorry, I'm misunderstanding people at the moment. Put leading O's on your file numbers so they stay in order on the file system. That's a very good point. That would make much more sense. So the point that Greg Blends is making, so if I go to file save, I will save another file so you can see what he's talking about. So I actually often do this when I'm doing my collection, but I haven't here. So I tend to order things in date anyway, so I don't worry too much about them. And I don't usually have so many files in one thing, but are we almost 300? We're not quite 300. I'm only on 259. It's gone down slightly, so people are getting bored of me, I'm afraid. but if I prefix it with 05 or something, then we know that that will, if I just bring that back up, save as, that will then definitely go to the top of the list, and that's probably a better way of doing it, because if I put 01, 02, then it will be in order, and that would make much more sense. And that's the way I should be doing it. Yes, thank you for that, Greg Blends. I missed the stream. Will you post it on as a video? Yes, indeed. Always do. And it's in a playlist with other streams as well. Do check out my playlists because I'm trying to organize the channel. I do want to get my website a bit more sorted. Oh, my face was in front of that whilst I was talking, wasn't it? Oh, you get your face out of there. So that's what I mean by the prefixes there, the 05, and then there'd be an order. Anyway, I'll cancel that. So let's just put that in render mode. In fact, no, it's better in object mode, isn't it? So that can be in the background. And there. Anyway, so yeah, we're not quite to 300. We're losing people, in fact. People know it's come to the end. I think you can use a hashtag for naming numbers too. I don't know about that, but probably true. Hello from Brazil. I know your channel now. The bad looks great. Thanks very much. We're just rounding things up. So if you just joined us, then do catch up with the rest of it on YouTube. I will post it. Does smoothing vertices increase the poly count? No, it's just a way of rendering the light information. I meant the likes. Oh, I see. I see what you mean. Yes. So we're almost there for 300 likes. I don't think we're going to make it today. Thanks very much for joining me. So, yep, I'll round things up there. Looking forward to tomorrow already. So between 3 and 5 is looking the most likely. It might have to be 4 and 6. It might have to be a bit earlier. Sorry if people are going to miss out. But remember, you can get the streams on YouTube. And I was saying, wasn't I, I'm trying to sort out my website a bit, but I'm not getting a lot of time to do that. But I'm trying to make sure that things are in playlists. So if you want to find the courses, they should be in playlists. And I'm just going through making sure things are nicely organized. So when you're looking on my channel, look on the playlist and that should help you find useful things. There was a big jump from the likes. We did get to 300. That's pretty funny. Thank you very much. That is great. Thank you very much for that. it does make me laugh. Thanks very much for the 300 likes as well, and mentioning that about the likes. It's always nice, that is. Anyway, so I'll round it up there. It's been really good fun, as always. I hope you have enjoyed it. Hello, Top Channel 101. do let me know of any thoughts you have in the comments, good or bad. So if I haven't done something very well, or gone on for too long, or whatever it is, let me know in the comments, because I do read them all, and I will take it to heart, take it on board. So that's great. Thanks, friend Tendo. Thanks, Unleash75. Rutger 10 Brink, fabulous milestone. Yes, 300. Eric Johnson, thank you. And thank you all. It's difficult to understand, Otto. I'm glad you're still joining us. Thanks very much for joining us anyway. So thanks to all those people. It's all coming on now. Thank you. Do, if you're missing out, then Discord server, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, I post it all on there. So, and it goes to everyone on the Discord server. So you know you're going to see it on the Discord server. It's another way. Anyway. Thanks very much, and look forward to seeing you all and hearing from you all tomorrow. Bye-bye.